said and I've been tweeting out all day, LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, I wanted to make this episode very big tonight due to the fact that I'm going to have certain people watching this episode, and I told them that, you know, it's a good time, it's entertaining. I try to give as much energy as possible. I wear the suit. I mean, I have the cup. You know what I mean? Like, I do it all. I'm trying. I have my jersey in the background. I have my hat over there. That's just what I do. So let's try to have a good show tonight. Like I said, the first two guests are going to be coming to me from Fear Supremacy. Now, to give you guys a little bit of background, they are a fairly familiar to esports as it is. They just haven't touched the esports gear scene. They actually are coming to esports gears for the first season. This first season, sorry, season two for Mexico. They did pick up a roster. Their captain is RetroShot. I'm actually having him on the show today, as well as one of the co-owners, Diamond LTD, on Twitter. If you guys don't know him, you guys will know him by the end of tonight. Now, why I wanted to bring Fear Supremacy in here and Vanquish Gaming in here is we welcome organizations. Organizations are, you know, they're hardworking, hard-paying people. They come into this gear scene. They spend their money on their team, on their players. They spend money to go to these events, and they spend money on their branding and their representation. Sorry about that. So the more orgs, the better. Obviously, I talked about this way back in, I think, episode two. I brought in a couple of different orgs and so forth. And this is, you know, exciting news. The fact that we have two more orgs that already jumped into the esports gear scene, and the season hasn't even started. That's what's crazy. And that's what we're working here, especially what I'm working here. I'm trying to get the more orgs in here the possible. I actually had two other orgs contacting me today before I even went live, asking me some information in regards to, you know, what orgs should expect from players, and, you know, what is really the gear scene and what it brings. Now, oh, DomezTV, thank you for the host. DomezTV is going to be one of our guests tonight. I appreciate that host. Again, it's already starting to begin. We're going to hit probably 100 viewers before you get on here, Chris. I appreciate that, buddy. Never a selfish move to do that. Love you. So, back to the orgs. First topic, orgs are us. I thought it'd be funny. You know, I'm trying to just get a little bit creative with the topics, but I don't want you guys to sit here and listen to me continue to ramble and talk about myself and talk about the show. Why don't we get the guys in here that matter? I'm going to be bringing in, like I said, Diamond LTD and at RetroShot. They're going to be coming on here and talking about the org and about themselves. So if you guys can give me a couple of seconds or two, I'm not going anywhere. I'm just going to go ahead and get them on Skype. They should be ready to go. I did speak to them prior. I always like to talk to my guest of the show prior to having them on. It just makes it a little bit easier for them for preparation purposes and so forth. But calling them right now. Hopefully we can get them in here. Yep. What's up, Zach? I know Retro is joining in. My man. Right, that should be good.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you good, buddy.
Gotcha.
All right, gentlemen, how's it going? You guys hear me?
Can you hear Cubano? No, right?
No, I can't hear him.
Uh-oh. Hold on, guys, we're having a little bit of a audio issue. Check this out. Contacts. Old microphone. Ah, there we go. You guys hear me?
Correct. Yeah, we hear you.
Awesome. There we go. Yeah, I just had switched out my microphone from my Astros. So, gentlemen, glad to have you guys on here. Zach, Andrew, these are the guys. This is at Diamond LTDs on the top of your screen. His name is Zach. We have Andrew RetroShot. Player for Fear Supremacy. I want to thank both of you guys for coming on the show. You know, if you guys feel free to introduce yourselves, give us a little spiel about you, a little bit of a background, and whoever wants to start can start.
Sure. I'll go ahead and take it from the top.
Gotcha.
Yep. So my name is Zach, or last name Crane. I am a senior student about to graduate in philosophy. I am the owner of Fear Supremacy, as well as a secondary team that is mainly in Call of Duty. And let's see here. I think that's pretty much it. I'm the overall owner at Fear, and really excited about branching into Gears now. And so just big high hopes from Retro and the team. So send it over to Retro.
Hey, everybody. My name is Retro Shot Andrew. I'm the captain of the Gears Fear Supremacy team. You know, shout out to the guys Resist here, Wake and Ty, Chansey, and Michael. They're the roster that we're going to be going to Mexico with and then continuing into Season 2 with. And, you know, we're very excited to represent Fear and everything that, you know, we can collab and bring to the table together.
Awesome. Good to hear. Now, Retro, did you change up any people before you came on the show? I thought I heard Chansey. Was he always on the roster, or is that like a new addition to the team?
Oh, all right. So I guess we'll start with that. So originally, the roster was not Chansey or Michael. The roster was Seduceful and Applicates. You know what I mean? After lots of film watching, after lots of team brainstorming, after lots of coming together, we decided to go ahead with the roster change. Right now, we have the opportunity to grab Chansey and his brother, who are a team of two, who have placed 17th and 25th at Vegas and Atlantic City. So, you know, we're very comfortable. We're very confident with them. They're great players. They're great amateur players. And, you know, I mean, hopefully they can help us get to that next level that we want to get to.
Awesome. Well, that's good to hear. I didn't know that he was a duo with his brother. Obviously, that's great news for you guys. I've played against him a couple of times. I've seen him at events. He's a great player. He brings a lot of energy. He has the skill, obviously. He's been to events. That's always great experience to have in a player, especially in a teammate that's going to be playing alongside with you at a, you know, at events. Now, for you, Zach, being that, you know, you're the org owner, in regards to team changes, are there things, are those things that you want to see happen often, not happen often? Like, give me a little bit insight on that, on roster changes, just because, you know, that's not something I usually ask the org owners. And I know, you know, I'm sure people have plenty of questions about that.
Sure. Yeah, absolutely. So I guess from a standpoint of org owner and, you know, looking to send a team to an event, roster changes are, they're kind of hit and miss. Sometimes it can be really good. Sometimes you can, you know, make a nice quick change and it actually turns out to work pretty well. But majority of the time it does backfire just because the time isn't there. You know, the communication and the relationship between players isn't as strong. Obviously, you know, if you've got a couple talented people that you can bring in for a set amount of time, it can work out. Generally, at what I look for is a roster that is have been very steady with each other. Changes are fine as long as the changes are agreed upon within the team that's still remaining. You know, you don't want to have any burnt bridges when leaving a team or joining a new one. You want to try to keep everything as professional as possible and on par. So the biggest thing I would have to say is if you're going to make a roster change, do it sooner than later. You don't want to make any last-minute changes because as an org owner, that it doesn't necessarily show that you can't, you know, play so you can't do well. It just the peace of mind that comes from a team that's been practicing together, been communicating together, been working really hard for the same goal, that alone is a really big driving force. And so for that mentality to be maintained and, you know, continued to the events is really, really, really big. So as far as roster changes go, if you're going to do them sooner. And, you know, make sure that everybody on the team is at least in agreement with them or at least understands why they are happening and that the issues come to light.
Yeah, I mean, that was a lot to say on that topic, which is great, but I agree with you completely. If you're going to make the roster change, usually you want to do it quicker than later, you know, faster than, sooner than later. Sorry, God, I'm getting all mixed up. Sooner than later, especially when you're coming to an event, which, you know, we're not too close to the event, which is great. You know, at least now the guys have a little bit more time to work with their new players, especially if you got a minimum, at least a month or less than that, you want to make this change. You want to make it quick. You know, yeah. You have great insight on that. You know, that was a great answer. I honestly thought you were going to say something else like most owners would say, but you know what? That's having an open mind, which obviously you need in this kind of industry in general, which people don't understand. Roster changes happen in every single thing, baseball, basketball, football, eSports especially, so you know it happens. That's a good, you know, that's a good mentality to have in regards to that. Now, switching over to you, Retro, Andrew, with Gears of War. I know you've been really passionate about Gears of War. You're actually really freaking good at Gears of War, I'm not going to lie. What made you play Gears of War? What was your driving goal to play Gears of War? Like, what happened?
Well, back in the day, you know, I mean, I always played a lot of video games. I was never into the competitive scene that you see me now. Until I really started watching my cousin play. My cousin, a lot of Gears, old Gears players probably remember him. His gamertag was Warning, all spaced out, all capitalized. He was big. He used to play like with Demo. He used to play with a couple of those guys before they got really big. But you know, I used to sit down and I used to watch him play, and it just became something that I'm very passionate about. You know, it's very fun to compete. It's super fun to get your skill out there, to beat other people, to get that smack talking. You know, it's very fun, especially in a game like Gears of War, where when you are winning, it's a very dominant win. But other than Call of Duty, where it's kind of like everything's kind of quick, in Gears of War, when you're losing, you're really losing. You know what I mean? They're giving to you.
So I agree.
It's something
agreed.
That I actually really like about the game. It's something that, you know what I mean, really drew me to it, and I just grinded singles. You know, I just kept grinding singles and singles and singles until my cousin said, "All right, you're good enough to kind of play with us now."
That's awesome. That's, you know, that's obviously you started from the bottom, and hopefully you get here. I hope that first event, dude. I want you guys to go big. Now, coming into this, Zach, this is going to be for you. Fear Supremacy. What was the mindset, or what brought you guys to Gears of War coming into this, you know, season two?
Gotcha. Yeah. So before season two, we were looking at Gears teams and trying out a couple different rosters, and one thing kept coming up after another was roster changes. And back in, I believe, when was Vegas? Was that in?
That was, if I'm not mistaken, that was July.
July. Yeah. Before July, we had a pretty solid roster. I was hopeful, but, you know, business is business, and I could see the way things were playing out. But I was still backing them. They still had my support because, I saw the time they were putting in. I saw the effort and the work. And, you know, I wanted to reward the guys for the time that they've put in. And they ended up making, like, a couple last-minute roster changes that I just really wasn't comfortable with. And we just ended up not going through with it. And it was really a shame because we had spent a lot of time and a lot of resources trying to get everything together to make it the best, even if we didn't place, you know, top 6, top 12, whatever, trying to make it the best event possible for the guys that are going as well. And it didn't have my full support, and that's one thing that I really look for is support between players and coach, as well as the owners and the investors. And we just had a couple last-minute roster changes that we just really weren't comfortable with, you know, committing and sending full resources to. And that was kind of unfortunate. We mainly stick to the Call of Duty scene, but we've had our eyes on Gears for a really long time because of the community and how dedicated, you know, not only the devs are, but also the, you know, the casters and the players who really enjoy the game itself. And watching competitive Gears is very, very fun as a spectator. At least it is for me. And so it just goes back to your first question, which was the roster changes. It ultimately came down to that being the reason why we did not attend MLG Vegas. But we are very hopeful, very, very proud the way these guys have been playing. The time, the effort, the dedication that they've shown is above previous rosters or anything that we've seen before. So they've got our full support, and we're really looking to make a name for ourselves here and at least place on the boards. So
yeah, I mean, that's really the goal of it. I know you guys coming in as an org, like you said, you haven't been in the esports gear scene. You know, I think you have the roster to do it. They could, you know, they're young, they're hungry, they want to win, and that's all it takes. Honestly, one event, you just bring in a team, that team places extremely well, your org is on the map, especially if you make pool play, which is very, people think it's hard, but it's very easy to make, especially if you have a good team. I've made it multiple times, you know, and that's great advertisement for you guys. If you guys could get into pool play, you got your logo on everything. You guys are going to have interviews, you guys are going to have your media day, which is extremely awesome, and I'm sure you guys will love it, you know, being org owners, being players. It's, you know, it's a great feeling for you personally, and that's just step one you know, because once you get into day two, Saturday, you know it's grind time. And once you hit Sunday, boom, you already hit pro. You're playing for top eight. Every match counts. It's do or die on Sundays. Absolutely. Sundays are the best days when it comes to esports. Absolutely. I'm sure you guys know that. You going to say something, Andrew?
Oh, no, I said Championship Sundays.
Championship Sunday, bro. That's it. Yeah. Once you get in there, it's a whole different world. You got to let the adrenaline pump. You know, you got to get your teammates hyped up. I'll see you guys there. I'm sure you'll be there. I'll be excited to be watching. Retro Shot, going into Mexico, what are your expectations for yourself and for your team?
You know, going into Mexico, this is going to be my third major now. I went to Atlantic City. I went to Vegas. I played pretty well in both. In Vegas, I had a map where I had 59 kills. I don't know how that happened, but you know what I mean? That
came to me. Impressive. That
was very fun. Yeah. It was insane. But, you know, we didn't play too well at Vegas. I went in with the roster that I had only prepared with for about 2 to 3 days, which was a terrible idea. In Atlantic City, it was maybe about 2 weeks, and I wasn't too comfortable with that either, you know what I mean? But as you learn and as you grow, you start playing with, you know what I mean, more serious players, players that want it more, and just, you know what I mean, it definitely shows in not only the people that you play with, but in the people that you play against. Mexico City expectations, I do believe that we can place in the top eight. I honestly do believe that, you know what I mean? We still have a month and some change of practice, lots of 2Ks, lots of film watching, lots of chemistry growing. I definitely am very confident in this roster, you know, especially with the Chansey and the Blossom edition. They're great players. Chansey is an amazing player. He's going to definitely up our game a lot.
Yeah. And
the two additional on the roster change, that experience, as from how I view the scene and the situation that's, you know, coming up for the event, knowing that we're going to have some more experience and, you know, just knowing that the guys are going to go in with, you know, the energy and excitement that they need, but also the experience to back up and to make sure they stay on focus and whatnot. So it's really exciting. It really, really is.
Yeah, I know. I mean, Mexico apparently is the best event for Gears of War. I'm sure you guys are excited about that. I couldn't make it to the first Mexico event. Probably might not make this event. I'm not too sure yet, but I heard it's amazing. I heard it's a great experience. The fans are wild there. They love Gears of War. They love the Gears of War players. They love the trash talk. I mean, they support every aspect of the game. So for something like that, what do you think going into it, both of you? You know, hearing all that excitement, what does that feel for you guys, or what kind of excitement does that bring to you?
Do you want to take that, Zach, or do you want me to?
You can throw it from a player standpoint first.
All right. So, you know, from a player standpoint, just going back to my first ever local, going in extremely confident and just seeing how much of a difference that land makes, how much of a difference that crowd, those oohs and ahs behind you, you know what I mean? They definitely do play a big factor in how you play. The last Mexico City event had a huge crowd. It was at a point where they were doing like kiss cams and everything. It was like packed out. So, I mean, I'm super excited to get on main stage to hear those, you know what I mean, those chants, those crowds, those oohs and ahs behind me when you're making big plays. And, you know, hopefully we play big when it matters. I definitely think we will. And I'm going into it, you know, with a level head, man. We have just as much a chance. We grind the game. We do extremely well in our fights. And it kind of just comes with chemistry, shooting for each other. Everything else kind of just falls into place. The more you know what I mean, you can't cheat the grind. The more you grind the game, the better you get.
Yeah, I'm right there with you. I am absolutely ecstatic with the way that they've been working and how they've been playing together. Just seeing them, you know, take it to that next level just makes it even more exciting for me as an owner to be able to, you know, watch these guys go out on the main stage where there is so much excitement, so much love for Gears. You know, it just adds to the whole event, the whole experience. You know, going to a LAN itself as a player has a special place. You know, even if you don't place, it's still really exciting to go and to be on that stage and to hear the crowd and to make those plays. You know, it's something special, and I'm really excited for these guys to get out on the stage and for the crowd to hear them. You know, see how they play and just really get behind them and support these guys just as much as we do. And It's really, really exciting. I just cannot stress that enough. And, you know, with the way the roster's turned out, the way they've been scrimming, going over film, it just builds up to that one moment, you know, when they get their shot. And so just super, super excited to see these guys, all their time and work pay off, be on the stage, you know, like you said, get the oohs and the ahs, make the plays, you know, hit some kill cams, get some nice shots. So it's just overall, it's just super exciting and immensely excited for them to be on the stage and to walk out and to represent us.
Yeah, of course. That's all good news. Obviously, we don't know when the next event is or when the next couple events are. So now we're kind of just on standby. Obviously, you guys are going to have your practice routine. You guys are going to be doing your thing. Obviously, I want to wish you the best to both of you. If you guys ever need any help, any questions, you know, if you ever need me to sit in on a scrim, you know, I'm willing to help you guys out. I do appreciate you both coming on. Is there any final words that you guys have for the stream?
Definitely thanks for having us. You know what I mean? We really appreciate the time you took to make this. What's up to all the viewers? You know what I mean? Hope you guys are enjoying it. We're definitely looking to represent Fear Supremacy and make a big splash in season two, man. We definitely are. Well, we're ready, man. We're grinding.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm right there behind them. And I mean, words just can't really put into the time and effort these guys are putting in. So definitely be on the look for us. Definitely look for some big things out of these guys. The next month and a half is going to be prime time grind time, so you know they're going to be going just as hard as they were before, even harder. So definitely be on the lookout for us, and when you see us, give us a shout.
Awesome. Well, thank you, gentlemen. I want to thank you guys for coming on once again. We are going to keep it going on the show. Make sure you guys stay tuned. We have a lot more to come. I'm going to be trying to get Domes on here if he's ready. But again, thank you guys for coming, and I will talk to you soon enough. Thank you, gentlemen. Good.
Appreciate your time.
Bye.
Take care. All right, so that was fun. I want to thank those two guys again, for all of you, for coming on the show, for speaking their mind, for telling us a little bit about their organization, about their team, what their practice schedule is. Because when it comes to pro gaming and when it comes to esports, it's not just, you know, show up and shoot your gun like a lot of people say now these days at events. There's a lot more to it. You also have to be very professional. These guys were willing to come on the show, you know, a little bit short notice. You saw how they dressed up real nice. All that stuff shows a lot. You know what I mean? To me, that's a big deal. And, you know, they really proved me right, I guess, or whatever you want to call it. So thank those guys at Fear Supremacy, at Retro Shot T, and at Diamond LTD. Again, those guys are an org owner from Fear Supremacy and one of the players slash captain of the team as well, Retro Shot. So going forward, I am going to be bringing on DomezTV. Now, DomezTV is a big part of the show tonight, and one of the reasons why this is going to be a great show. Domes is one of my former teammates. His name is Chris. He lives in New York City. Of course, like 95% of the Gears of War community, if I'm mistaken, tell me. But he has a lot to talk about. He's going to be talking about content creation. Content creation is very important now these days, especially in the, I guess you say, the tech world that we're in. He does a lot of videos on Gears of War, on his scrims. I think he does like voiceover sometimes as well. So he stays very busy. He has his own routines that he does in regards to videos. So he's going to be coming on here and explaining all of that to you. He's a great guy to have on here. Like I said, he's very knowledgeable. One of my former teammates, we actually played together at Columbus. We placed top 12 together. I love playing with Chris. It was some of the best times. I played with Chris, God Plays, Kaid, and Kevin Rezik. You guys all know them. They're all pro players. Just playing with those guys was so much fun. I'm 25, and I think Chris was 17, 18. They're all like in their 17, 18 age range, and these guys were hysterical. The stuff we did at the events was fun. I love playing with them. So Chris comes dear to me in this episode, and if I can get Chris on here, we are going to continue to move forward. I have been contacting Chris. I'm hoping he didn't sleep on me. Chris does like to sleep a lot, so let me give him a call. I think you guys could hear the Skype noise. Getting ready. All right, cool. Chris, give me a call when you're ready. So that is Chris, DomezTV. He just tweeted, messaged me on here for you guys to see. He's getting ready. So, Chris, when you are ready, call me on Skype and we'll get this started. But on other news, at Hite Gaming, H-I-T-E Gaming, has picked up a Latin American team for Season 2 Mexico event. Now, Hite Gaming is also an organization that I work well with. One of the owners, Harrison, actually just picked up the team yesterday. They tweeted it out. They did pick up a top three Latin American team, so they are going to get their full funding travel coverage to the event. I actually consulted with Harrison in regards to picking up that team and told him that I thought it was worthwhile. That team is great. They have a lot of potential. Obviously, the only way you can build as a team is if they stay together. I told Harrison those are the biggest issues when it comes to Gears of War and teams. The more you guys stick together, the more you play together as a unit, the more you go through the goods and bads of esports, the better you become as a team. One of my teams, Raw Talent, one of the longest teams I played with, which Immortal Spawn was actually on that team. He's going to be my guest talking about Trickstrat, the owner of that company. He is going to be on here, and him and I have been teammates for 10 years. Now, I can't tell you the benefits of having a teammate for that long. I mean, we literally don't need to talk, and we know what we're doing. We know our pros, we know our cons. So the fact that you have teams who change players in and out all the time doesn't necessarily benefit you. Yeah, you had a bad map. Yeah, you had a bad day. Maybe you guys argued, but you know what? That happens. We're all human. It's human instinct. We all have our goods and our bads. So as teammates, you have to be able to pick each other up, especially at a time like that. Say you had a bad map or a bad event or something like that. You go and talk to them and say, hey, look, it happens. Come back stronger. And the potential is there. So speaking about Hite Gaming, I wish them the best of luck. They're going to be going to Mexico City. They do have their team pass. Harrison, I wish you the best of luck, my friend. He is in the stream. Make sure you guys give them a follow. I also have a command that I made for tonight's stream. I just put it up there. Make sure you guys follow at Hite Gaming for your chance at being entered into their COD World War II beta code giveaway. I'm almost positive their code works for both PS4 and Xbox One. So no matter what, if you guys win it, you're getting it. So make sure you give them a follow. Dome said to give him about 5 minutes and he'll be on here. If you guys have any questions throughout the whole show, make sure you go put them in the chat. Questions will be coming, you know, through the show and through the message board. If you guys ever have anything about a guest that was on here or whatnot, make sure you let me know. And yeah, now we just wait. We wait for Domes. Domes is going to be on here soon enough. Then we're going to be having Vanquish members. We're going to have Strive. He's a coach / Gears of War player for years now. Like I said, he is coaching the Vanquish squad that is also going to Mexico City. And we're also going to have Rep Solid, who's the captain of Vanquish Gaming. Now, Vanquish Gaming was actually sold prior to this episode. They were sold, I think, for a couple of months now. I actually represented Vanquish Gaming at the first event, Columbus, Ohio, with Domes, actually, with Domes and Mortal Spawn, that team. We actually represented Vanquish at the first event. The owner, Chris, actually sold the I guess, team or the name or the logo, whatever you want to call it. He actually sold it to, I think, a group of three guys. I was actually supposed to get one of their org owners in on here, and unfortunately, he couldn't make it tonight. So that's why we're bringing on Strive and Rep Solid, the coach and the captain, to give us a little bit more of a breakdown of their relationship with the organization and what they think about Season 2 and Mexico City being the first event. I know they've been grinding. I jumped in one of their scrims yesterday and watched him for a little bit. I also started talking a little trash, and I wasn't even playing. That's the best part. But once they come on and we speak to them, we're going to be doing a league of their own. That's the third topic of the night. A league of their own was something I wanted to do with Panda. Panda unfortunately had a personal issue that came up, and she couldn't make it. I'm very sorry to not have her on here. She will be on here next week. I rest assure you to her and to you guys that she will be on here. She'll be talking about her Gears of War experience, her experience as a female gamer in the esports world. Obviously, it's not something that we all come encounter with every day, and I thought she'd be the best person to kind of come on here and talk about it. That's something that I thought would be pretty cool, being that esports is always, you know, usually considered a man thing, which it's not necessarily true. There's a lot of esports girls out there, and sometimes they're just not willing to, you know, express themselves enough or really put it out there. And us as guys stink. We need to do a better job of including them into teams. Panda actually played at Las Vegas this past event, and she beat some decent teams. You know what I mean? So it doesn't matter if you're a female, you're a guy, you can do it. All you got to do is dedicate your time and the motivation and the positive energy. Positive energy takes you a long way. So unfortunately, we didn't have her on here tonight. We will be talking a little bit about that later, though, being the fact that she's not here. And then lastly, we're going to be talking about Trick Strat. Now, Trick Strat is going to be the biggest thing we have on this show tonight. Let me tell you a little bit about Trick Strat. I'm not going to tell you much about it, but we're going to let Immortal Spawn, the professor, tell you about it. Trick Strat is a gaming application, okay? It's a map designed that you can put on your PC, you can put it on an iPad, you can put it on your cell phone, you can pull it up on your computer, you can pull it up pretty much anywhere. If you're at work and you're like, you know what, I need to go over my map, I need to improve my game, you pull it up. So that's an awesome idea that we're going to be bringing in tonight. Immortal Spawn is going to be telling you guys the ins and outs, the pros. There is no cons, obviously. We don't work with cons here, all right? We're all about the pros. So he's going to talk about that. He's going to tell you how you can break down the map, how it's going to be extremely awesome for Gears of War, especially for those coaches like Coach Drive. We're going to question him tonight about it, if he's downloaded the app yet. If he hasn't downloaded it, there's a problem, because I think every coach needs to have this. So that's what we're going to finish up with tonight. It's going to be some Q&A with Immortal. So make sure you guys save all your questions, your concerns, your good feedback is welcome. If you guys have any bad feedback, not that it's bad, but feedback that you think he can work on, make sure you put that in this in the stream as well. You guys can also tweet at him, at Immortal Spawn, IMMORTALSPAWN. I actually made a command for that as well, but I wanted to spell it out so it looked kind of cool. But yeah, that would wrap up the night for that. Andrew, well, everybody welcome Andrew, my good friend Andrew. He actually works at Major League Gaming. I love him, always been a fan of ours, a good friend of ours, myself, my teammate slash friend Dan, Rob, Immortal Spawn as well. Great guy. We love him. Thank you for showing up, buddy. We're still waiting on Domes. Domes, what do you think of the countdown is? Everyone's waiting for you. We're trying to get this going. This guy, I already know what Domes is up to. He probably has a video, or he's probably, you know, putting on a suit or something like that. He's always has something up his sleeve. So I'm happy. I'm giving him the time he needs. It's either that or he's getting yelled at by his mom. Domes is a Dominican. I'm Cuban and Ecuadorian, so we kind of relate. He's usually getting yelled at his mom for doing something or not doing his chores, so I'm sure that's probably what he's doing right now, and he doesn't want to say it. But hopefully he could clear that up so we could get this show going. I know you guys don't want to look at me. I'm not the prettiest looking person, but I try. You know what I mean? I do my hair for the show. I wear the tie, the suit. I had the cup that was made, Vistaprint.com. Hey, maybe I could get them to sponsor me, you know what I mean? But yeah, so Wicked Crazy has a question for me. What happens if the Coalition makes the same kind of app with the official maps and such? That would suck. I don't think that's gonna happen. I know the Coalition did see that Immortal Spawn put it out there. Jack Felling actually congratulated Immortal Spawn for that. So they did acknowledge the fact that he did make that app. And, you know, that's a good thing. You know, obviously they know that he made it and there's no questions being asked. There is Conquer app. They're another, I guess, company that's doing something similar or so. But hey, Trick Strat was the first announced. Trick Strat is where it's at. I'm obviously a big supporter of Trick Strat. My new overlay that's going to be coming out, I'm going to be having sponsorship board on the top of my screen. I'm going to have a Trick Strat logo on there with their follow, which is great. I'm going to have Hype Gaming. I wasn't going to say anything, but Hype Gaming is also going to be one of the sponsors of our show. They're going to be powering the Roster Mania show. But yeah, we'll talk about that a little later. Domes is actually calling me right now. What up?
What's up, bro?
What's happening?
Chilling. You know, I love you, right?
Of course. Yeah, I was waiting for you, man. I'm like, the crowd wants him. Let's go. Where is this guy?
I fought, bro.
Nah, you're good. What's happening? I'm trying to get you on the screen so everyone can see you.
You can't see me?
I just have to fix this screen. I can find it. Where did it go? Sorry about that, guys. I'm just trying to pull them up on the screen. I do have it. It's at the bottom of my screen somewhere. Let's see, Chris. Okay, we'll do this. That. Do a window capture. All right, awesome. There he is. Sorry about that, guys. A little new to this whole tech thing, but I'm working on it little by little each episode. It's not the easiest thing for me. Obviously, this isn't something I do on a daily. But there we go. So, Chris, happy to have you here. You have a lot to talk about. I know you've been on your grind with your team, with your YouTube content creation. You've been doing it all, which is awesome. And I'm happy to have you on here. Chris, for the people that don't know much about you or about what you do, why don't we start off with that? Give us a little bit of a kind of an introduction for yourself.
Basically, I'm a Gears of War pro player. I placed pro at Mexico. That was probably my worst event ever, as in, like, experience-wise, it was fine, but Crushmo ended up clutching a 1v3 at our home hill, 6-6 tiebreaker, 209-140. So that's probably my worst experience in GAL so far. I also create content on YouTube at DomezTV. I have about 4,200 subscribers, almost 4,300. I've gained about 2,000 subscribers in the past 30 days, which isn't bad at all. It's actually a really big accomplishment for me. And yeah, I just want to talk about content creation and whatever other questions you have.
Of course. Yeah, I think the biggest question that we have tonight and the biggest topic we're going to be talking about is content creation. Like you said, you have a pretty decent following already on YouTube as well as subscribers. Tell me a little bit of how you got into that. What was your first step going into YouTube and, you know, starting with your first video?
That's actually funny because my idea behind it, I was going to start up a tutorial-only channel, so I upload tutorials. And it got to the point where I was uploading so many, like, tutorial videos that I ran out of, like, tutorials. There was nothing else I could explain. And I was like, my first video had, like, 800 views. I ain't gonna lie to you guys. It had, like, 800 views. I was so pissed. And I was pissed due to the fact that, like, Avexis, Neglectin, like, all of them, they had more subscribers than me. And I was like, my goal right now is to be, like, to pass them in subscribers. So I started uploading videos every day, literally nonstop. Tutorial videos, gameplay videos, anything that had to do with Gears of War, I was uploading. And I uploaded a controller tips and tricks video, like best settings on the controller. And that's probably the video that made me blow up on YouTube. It ended up hitting like 72,000 views in like a month or two.
Holy crap.
So yeah, that's probably my biggest video on YouTube. It ended up blowing up on YouTube on Gears of War section. That's basically how I started off on YouTube. And right now I'm still uploading like gameplays, scrims. And I've been preaching this since day one. If people like Fran, Explosive, Mental, Summons, like all these people uploaded videos that were involved with scrims, I kid you not, like the viewership on YouTube would be insane. Because Mental has a fan base, Praise has a fan base, Fran has a fan base. All these top players have fan bases and they don't use it to their advantage. Summons right now is the one that's uploading a lot of videos right now, so I respect him for that. Ashes too is uploading content. And I feel like if the pro community like got together and uploaded content together, that's the whole part of my YouTube team now that I started. My goal right now is to upload content with at least players that I feel comfortable making YouTube videos with. Keem is on my team, my YouTube team, Drix, Zerpting, Zeus, and he actually is really, really, he's decently big on YouTube right now. He has like 22,000 subscribers. He averages like 5 to 10K views a video, sometimes even more than that. So I partnered up with people that I know that want to grind and make videos. Nunez, I just picked him up too. And Shinies and me got something really big coming up, and I can't really talk about that right now, but I'm 90% sure we're going to be the biggest Gears of War channel on YouTube once this happens. Once this drops, we're going to be the biggest Gears of War channel on YouTube when it comes to like the NA community in the United States.
That's impressive. I mean,
yeah.
That'd be awesome if that happens. I mean, obviously, I wish you the best of luck with that, but that's insane. You know what I mean? YouTube is a big deal, especially now these days with the content creation in general. I mean, look at Nateshot. Look how he went from pro player to 2.2 million followers or something like that on Twitter that I just checked earlier today because I saw him release a video.
I wanted to start doing that too. I wanted to not only do GAL content, maybe like vlogs and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
That's right now I'm saving money to do that. I want to buy a PC. I want to start doing vlogs. And I'm not going to lie to you, I feel like I'm going to get into the prank section when I start pranking people in my family. I don't know why, but I feel like I'm going to give it a go. Like, I don't know why, but I want to give it a try because you never know. FaZe, for example, they all went from, you know, Call of Duty content to make pranking people, doing daily vlogs. So that's right now what's popping on YouTube.
Yeah, I mean, that's awesome. I think that'd be interesting. I'd love to see you prank your family, especially your mom. But you better watch out, though. You're going to see a chocolate come through that door behind you. You better be careful.
I'm getting more than a chocolate, bro.
It's over for you if you prank around too much. But yeah, I think that'd be funny. You know what I mean? You got to be different. Anything that's different will succeed. And the fact that you were, you know, probably the first, if not one of the first Gears players to actually hit the ground running with the content. You know, Rob had been doing it for a long time now. Rob still does it every once in a while. I mean, obviously he hasn't scrimmed in a while, but Rob always just do it for pretty much every Gears of War. Even back in the Gears of War 1 days, Rob was a big content creator. So it's cool to see somebody like you, you know, younger, you're coming up and you're doing it already. You know the ins and outs. In regards to that, I know you were telling me prior to our, you know, our pre-interview.
Yeah.
I know you said there's like different strategies or different things that you do.
So
tell us about that.
So YouTube alone, like people just upload content to upload. Me on the other hand, bro, like before I even started uploading, like I was realizing my views are really low. I was like, bro, what's going on with my views? Like I'm dropping videos and I think it's pretty good. I'm like, it's not getting the views that I wanted to hit. And I started like literally like searching all throughout YouTube. Any old Gears of War content that was out in GAL 3, I was watching. I was like, I'm literally studying everything. First thing I noticed was the thumbnails. Thumbnails are like a really big part of YouTube. If you have like a clickbait thumbnail that wants the viewer to like to click on the video, because he's like, oh my god, this guy has a nasty thumbnail. There's a guy pop shot in this kid or whatever, a nasty headshot, or like you want people to engage with the video. So they see like the thumbnail, there's a really good thumbnail, they click on it. That's step number one. They have to click on the video alone. You have to have a good title. If you have a title that's like trash or like not engaging at all, they're not gonna click on the video. So thumbnail title was like the main idea for me. After I got the thumbnail and title down, I started literally searching up what's the best time to upload YouTube videos for. What I realized is that Monday through Friday, people are at school. People, if your audience is like teenagers, they're all at school at that time in the morning, like 8 a.m. So don't upload the video at 8 a.m. Do not upload the video at 10 a.m., 12. I upload my video at 4 p.m. knowing that that's the time everybody's getting home from school. And people on the West Coast, when they go to their YouTube analytics or whatever, the subscription box, the video is going to say posted 3 hours ago, and it won't be so far behind in their subscription box. Like, basically, it's like first come, first serve. If you upload a video at around 4 o'clock, they're getting home. They want to watch the video. They see this the first video they see, so they're going to click on it. So that was my way of doing it. So students are getting home at that time. They're going to click on that video because, like, it's around their time to get home from school. That's the first thing they want to do. So now YouTube is growing as a whole already. So people wanting to watch YouTube videos and rather – well, let me take that back. People rather watch YouTube videos than watch TV nowadays. And it's a fact. Netflix, too. People rather watch Netflix, YouTube. People don't really watch TV anymore. So them getting home and watching my video popping up on their timeline, they're like Gears of War fanatics. They're going to click on it and watch it. And another thing that I realized is that tagging your videos on YouTube also, like there's like a little tag box on YouTube. If you put keywords in there, when they're typing in YouTube, let's say they're typing in Gears of War tutorial, if you type in Gears of War tutorial in your YouTube tag, not in the title, your video will still pop up on their search bar. Once they search for the video, it'll still pop up as like recommended video. That's another trick. So if your tutorial video is like, let's say you don't put tutorial in the video, but it's actually a tutorial. Let's say you're dropping a video on Friday, and you're planning it to be a tutorial video for viewers, but you don't want to put a tutorial in the title because it's gonna be way too long. You put a tutorial in the tag box, it's still gonna pop up on the subscription not subscription box, on their video recommended list whenever they click on the search button. That's another trick that people don't know about. So it's literally like YouTube is all like a game, bro. Like people have a whole system for this YouTube thing, and people don't really know. There's like it's like mass stuff in YouTube that people do not know about. There's an algorithm. There's a way of people clicking on your videos. There's a way of people like engaging more in your videos. One thing I started realizing YouTubers were doing, they were putting like in the comment section to subscribe to their main channel. Or, like subscribe and they put the link. I wasn't doing that. I started doing that recently, and I started realizing there was like a boost on my subscriber count per day once I started doing that. So I started putting my YouTube subscription little code, whatever link. So once they click on that link, it automatically makes them follow my channel.
Very cool.
So that's another thing I started doing.
I should be talking to you. I upload these videos like right after the episode is done. I don't know. Now I'm like kind of trying to think, is that a good thing or a bad thing? Well, what would you say? Like once I'm done with the shows, I always go into my email. It says, you know, your show is ready or whatever, your link is ready to go. Would you automatically post that? You were doing that?
No.
What would you be your kind of strategy in regards to that?
So if I'm you and I'm uploading videos, what I would do after the show's over, upload your video around 3 p.m. Trust me, upload your video around 3 p.m. Get a good thumbnail. That's literally one thing I've been preaching. Upload a good thumbnail. You want to get a good thumbnail where people can engage. Zerting, for example, I actually didn't talk about it. You see, some of his YouTube videos they just dropped recently. You can go to his channel right now. You can probably look at it. His thumbnail that he has right now, I'm the one that made that thumbnail. It's an engaging thumbnail. It makes people want to click on it. I don't know if you can pull it up on your screen right now, but if you can pull up Summon's video on screen right now and look at his most recent video, that's going to probably be one of his most viewed videos because of that thumbnail. Like, it's a clickbait thumbnail that people are going to want to click on the video.
That's crazy.
Look at it yourself, and I'm going to tell you right now.
Yeah, yeah. DM it to me or whatever it is. But yeah, but tell me about it.
So the video has 9,200 views.
What?
And it's one of his most viewed videos right now. It's literally doing really good on his channel. I knew it was going to be a banger. Don't we tell me what it was about? I'm like, yo, bro, you need a clickbait thumbnail. Like, you literally need a thumbnail that's going to make people want to click on your video automatically. And the video right now in 2 days has 9,200 views, which is really good on YouTube. And I have a feeling this YouTube video that he has right now is going to hit like 20,000 views.
Wow.
Don't quote me on this, but I truly believe this video right here is going to hit 20,000 views. I'm going to DM you the video right now, but it has 9.2 thousand views right now. And I think it's going to hit 20K. I just truly believe it's going to hit 20K.
That's one of those wild.
Yep.
And that's a thumbnail for everybody. I'm talking for myself, too. I don't even know. A thumbnail, what is that? How do you go about doing that?
Okay, so a thumbnail is basically a preview of your video. So basically, the thumbnail, what you're really doing is before you click on the video, it has a little picture on the left. I know you've probably seen that.
Okay, yeah.
So basically, that's the thumbnail. The little box is a thumbnail. So you could put an image in there to make viewers want to engage with the video. So I put a picture of summons and identives. I put 81-0 on one side, 214-0 on another side. Then at the bottom, I put most intense match ever with a exclamation mark.
Okay.
The background, the map that they want to play on. If you're just uploading the video with no thumbnail, first of all, they're not gonna. Most Mexicans, I'm not trying to be mean, but most Mexicans, they don't really care about the title. They want to see the picture. I'm gonna see identities in the picture. They're automatically gonna click on it because Identity has a huge fan base already. I kid you, you're laughing, but it's true. They see Identity on the thumbnail, they click on it. And I actually did this not that long ago. I uploaded a video of being one winning Identity not that long ago. I had 16,000 views.
Literally a month. Oh my goodness.
So I know it works.
Oh,
I
Lord.
I literally know that putting Identity on the title, on the thumbnail, works. I don't know why. I don't know, bro. Identity's fan base is literally insane.
That is crazy.
I realized that, bro. I'm like, I had 60,000 views on the video. I'm like, yo, Adentus, I'm going to start fucking putting you on every fucking title and fucking every fucking thumbnail.
I mean, I got to have this guy on the show now and then put a thumbnail of, like, me and him standing next to each other, like, for a UFC poster or something, saying Adentus versus NJCUBANO on Roster Mania or something.
That's literally insane. Adentus' fan base is literally one of the most incredible fan bases I've ever had, and I'll be honest with you, when I uploaded that Adentus video, I gained 152 subs that one day. It's insane. It works. I uploaded that video. I didn't expect to get that much traffic, but once I uploaded that video, mad Spanish people were commenting on my videos, and I kept replying to everybody to make sure I'm engaging with them, like, to make sure they felt like a home, like they felt like I'm a part of, like, their family. Like, they were uploading, they were like talking to me, they're like, oh, Domes, eres el mejor, te amo. Like, they were talking to me in Spanish, and I was replying to everybody, mad hype. It's crazy, bro. It works. And there's nothing else I can say about it, bro. Literally, Adentus has a huge fan base on YouTube. Same thing with Summons. Mental has a huge fan base, and I don't think he even knows it, bro. I feel like he uploaded one video, a tutorial video, like a gameplay video of him just talking to his, like, not fans, more like his viewers. You'll get so many views and a good thumbnail. I don't know. I'm going to preach that thumbnail part so much because it's like an actual fact right now.
That's insane. Honestly, I mean, I believe it. But that's the whole reason why I wanted to have you on here. The fact that you're disclosing all this information is hilarious, one. And two, awesome. Like, why aren't people doing this? I got to go and make a thumbnail now. One of, I don't even know, myself and Immortal on it or something. I don't know. I got to do it. I got to have it.
Thing about it is, too, like, I started off on YouTube, and I'm not gonna lie to you, bro, like, I was doing it for fun. At the start, I was doing it for fun. I was doing it just to, like, upload content. I was making, like, $20 a month. I didn't really care about it. I'm like, I'm making $20 a month doing YouTube. I really don't care. I'm just upload videos here and there, like, once a month, twice a month, like, whatever. But what I realized last month, I started uploading one video a day. Just one.
Okay.
Consistently. So I think last month, I dropped, like, 20 videos, maybe. In like 30 days, which is like a really good average.
That's pretty good.
I go to my YouTube. I could disclose. I don't really care. Showing you guys how much money I make off of YouTube. I go to the YouTube thing, bro, and I made $423.
Wow.
I was literally mind blown.
That's awesome.
How I was uploading simple videos made me $423. I was like, dude, like, what the fuck? And I go to my subscriber count. I went to go look at the how many subscribers I gained. And it was over 2,000 subscribers in literally 30 days.
Wow, that's great. Like,
my channel literally doubled in subscribers in 1 month. And my viewership doubled in 1 month on YouTube. So I went from like 168,000 to like 300-something thousand in views.
Wow.
So I was like, I'm taking that, bro. I'm literally going to start uploading videos every day. And I started recently. Like I said, this whole month, August, even though I'm going to college right now, I'm literally going to try to upload one video a day at least. When I get home from class, any random video that I have an idea about or have a feeling going to be a banger, I'm going to just drop it.
No hesitation. I mean, at this point, look at the rate that you're getting, you know, your return on the viewership and on your subscribers. I mean, this is crazy, honestly. I'm kind of happy I had you on here to kind of give me this experience and this knowledge about YouTube. But holy crap, that's great. Now, in regards to that, how would your scrims like videos come out or the rest of your stuff? Not your tutorials or anything like that.
Okay, I'm going to talk about that too. So basically my tutorial videos, not tutorial, scrim videos. I feel like I'm playing scrims, but I'm also making money playing the scrim. So it's like a wager without me actually losing money. Every scrim I upload is like around $20, $20-$30. So let's say every map I upload is $20-$30. I'm uploading it. I was uploading it not knowing that I was going to get that many views on them. I've dropped the first video against, I think it was E-United. I made $25. And I was like, what the fuck? I'm going to drop another one. The next day, I scrimmed them again. Another $25. And I just kept on stacking up. And I was like, people kept on asking for the video. I didn't think people were actually going to like watching gameplay because I stream it on Twitch. And when I'm streaming on Twitch, I obviously don't have thousands of viewers watching it. So I'm expecting like at least 1,000 people to watch that video. But every single time I upload a pro match or whatever, a scrim or whatever, it's averaging 3,000 to 5,000 views per video. And that's a lot of views on YouTube, especially for Gears of War, which is the reason why I want more pro players uploading more content for Gears. especially people that have big names out there, Praise, Mental, all of them. If they start uploading videos like that, as gameplay videos or even scrims, I can't imagine how much money, not even money, just viewership-wise, how much the scene would grow.
Yeah, that's the scene alone and just the money, I mean, the incentive is there, obviously. And the fact that, like you said, they have a following and they haven't even started their videos. So, yeah, I mean, I don't understand, you know, why they haven't hit the scene. But, hey, better for you, you know what I mean? Less competition right now. So you should just continue to do your thing. Get a Denim's on there as much as possible.
Honest, I'm going to be honest with you. If they join if they start the YouTube grind, it's also going to help me. It's going to help everybody involved in the YouTube scene that's not even a pro player, just uploads like pro matches or scrims or anything like that. True. Why? Because I don't know if you ever heard about it, but the recommended list, they recommend the best related like videos that's recommended to like related to that video. So let's say Optic Mental uploads a scrim, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the recommended on the right side of the video is going to have like a whole bunch of videos that are related to scrims. My video could pop up on the right side of the screen by all I know. It's happened a few times. I watched Thursday's video and Summon's video. And both times that I watched their videos, some of my videos have popped up on the right side of the screen. But I'm guessing that's also how I'm getting some of these views, too.
Now that you say it like that, that's absolutely right. Yeah, if you get the recommendation list next to it, you'd probably show up on it on any of those players. So, yeah, absolutely. Wow. That's something to think about. God, that's pretty interesting.
If you're actually trying to get into the YouTube team, I'm actually down to help you. That's the whole point of me starting the YouTube team. It was to help each other grow. Like, me and Shinies, bro, like, you don't understand. Like, this thing we actually have planned out is going to be big. Like, I wish I could talk about it so you guys could actually know, but it's, like, actually insane how we came about this idea. It's like, I'm going to give you, like, a little, like, tease or, like, a hint. It's basically going to be a channel, like, a community channel.
Okay.
But what's going to be on it is, like, straight, like, jokes, like, comedy. Like, people can just go to the channel and have a laugh. Like, no serious, like, scrim videos, none of that crazy stuff. Like, just kind of going to make you laugh. So that's my whole objective with that channel. I want to make, like, a troll type of channel, like, a community channel, like, fails, stuff like that.
Okay.
Involved in that channel.
That'd probably be interesting. It'd be funny. It'd be different. You know what I mean? Unique a little bit.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, that'd be cool. I don't want you to disclose anymore. Obviously, I want it to hit the scene. But yeah, we got to talk after this. We got to, with this episode at least, I got to start the YouTube grind or whatever it is, because it's kind of, you know, I post these videos after every episode, and this is for you and everybody else that's watching. Yeah. I always put them up on YouTube. You know, they do all right. I'm not in the thousands like you're talking about, which is insane. But I'm sure with the proper help and the proper guidance from you, I'm sure, you know, I could get there. I mean, obviously, you've been doing it, and you're doing an awesome job with it, and you know the ins and outs. So I would definitely love to work with you on that. But in regards to anything else, Chris, is there anything else that you wanted to tell the stream? Anything else that you wanted to talk about just so we could start to wrap this up?
Roster changes, man. I gotta say.
Roster changes.
Well, last thing, bro. That's the last thing I want to talk about. Roster changes. This is what happened. So I want to talk about what happened with the last team I was on. Basically, well, I was playing with Clouds, Crash, Osby, Neglect, and Witchy, right?
Okay.
We were doing really good. Like, I don't know what was up with our roster, but when we first started the team, bro, like, we were beating Ghost. We was actually keeping up with Ghost. Like, if we lost a round to them or a map, it would be like 6-7. Like, we'll win 7-6. Like, it was going back and forth. Like, it was like a bloodbath for Ghost. And I don't know why or like how he was playing so well, because I never really like me and Neglect never really got along in game. Like, we always used to go back and forth. Like, Neglect, shut the fuck up. Like, nah, you shut the fuck up. Like, we're like arguing like retarded about dumb stuff. Yeah, so it was like bad. It was really bad, bro. Excuse my language, by the way. And then Osby was doing really well with us. Like, bro, any team we were scrimming, E-United, we was doing really well. Like, I don't know what's up with our roster. We was actually doing really well. But then Osby started getting, like, not undedicated, but, like, his schedule wasn't matching up with us. So, let's say we have a scrim for 11, he'll play one map with us and then, like, leave. And I'm like, yo, Osby, like, that got to stop happening, bro. He's like, I have to go to work at 5. I got to wake up at 5 a.m. I can't keep playing. So, we was like, we spoke to him and we dropped him because of his schedule. And every time you saw a Lancer on the floor, it was Osby's Lancer. Like, you'll know if it's Osby's Lancer because, like, you look at the skin and you see it's Osby's Lancer. Like, he was getting literally straight line. Like, he was trying to play way too smart. And he always was getting chucked with the Lancer. I'm like, yo, Osby, like, you gotta stop letting him bully you, bro. Like, we was getting mad at him, bro, to be honest. And then he was having microphone issues, too, with the headset. So I was like, it's whatever. Like, we just had to drop him. Like, he wasn't a bad player. It's just like his schedule sucked. So me, Neglect, and Klaus was like, yo, we need to find another one. Like, we need to find a replacement, whatever. That's when we got Crash. So Crash joined the team. I'm going to be honest, I didn't really want him on the team. I wanted Firearm, but I don't know if Klaus didn't want to give him a chance, so like, and Neglect never told them, but like, I offered to pick up Firearm a few times, and they said, nobody didn't really say no, but they didn't want to pick him up. Like, it was never brought, like, talked about. I'm like, yo, guys, let's pick up Firearm. Like, nobody ever, like, said, yo, let's pick him up, nothing. Like, I was the only person that wanted Firearm. So we ended up picking up Crash. Crash didn't want to play with me before he even joined the team. Like, they literally spoke to Neglect. He spoke to Neglect and Klaus. He didn't want to play with me before he even joined the team. So I'm like, yo, like, if he doesn't want to play with me, like, I don't want to force it, bro. Like, let's just pick up Firearm. Trust me. Never happened. We ended up picking up Crash. We spent 1 day, actually 2 days with Crash. We did bad the first day. The second day, we did better. But Crash didn't want to play with me regardless after he screamed at me. He's like, oh, don't you play too stupid, whatever. I'm like, all right, man. So we didn't scrim for 3 days after that in a row. I told Neglect, it was me and Neglect and watching a Skype call and on a party chat. And I said, yo, if it hits 7 p.m., and we're not scrimming, because it was the third day in a row we don't scrim, and the whole point of dropping Ozzy was because we weren't scrimming enough, I'm literally gone. Like, I literally told Neglect, and Neglect could literally vouch for me or whatever, because I remember he was in a party chat with me. It hit 7 o'clock. I was like, yo, I wrote a big-ass paragraph in the chat and left the chat. And at the end, Clouds, the same exact thing, told him. He said, bro, it's whatever. Like, it's just not working. Like, Crash just want to play with you. I'm like, all right, it's fine, bro. I don't care. I just want to play you guys online. That's what I told him. So that happened. I left. I started playing with Perfections and Flamesy and them. And they ended up breaking up anyways. Like,
Jesus.
That whole roster change thing was literally for no reason. We dropped Ozzy for no reason. We did all this roster changes and stuff. And, like, I'm thinking I left because I feel like I was low-key the problem. I'm like, yo, if you guys don't want to – if Crash doesn't want to play, I'm not going to force Crash to play. And you guys want to play with Crash really bad. So I'm like, yo, I'm just like, that's it. Just leave it at that. I feel like I was the problem at a certain point. I'm like, yo, like, maybe I'm the problem. Because every time we were watching my VOD, they're all coming at me. They're like, oh, don't, you're doing this dumb play. And I was like, guys, like, how am I the one doing the dumb mistakes when you got Witchy dropping single digits? That's, like, my argument. I'm like, you got Witchy dropping single digits, and you guys are not saying anything to Witchy. And then you got Klaus and Witchy losing platform, and you guys aren't saying nothing to Witchy. Like, why are you guys coming at me? I got 20. I ain't going to hold you, bro. I can't be doing that. But I was like, I got 28 kills on Damn when we lost, and I'm playing baby steps while you got Witchy with 7 kills. Like, I was heated. And I ended up telling them that, and I was just pissed off at the time because they kept on coming at me. So I was like, whatever, bro. We dropped it. Crash joined Rezik's team, and Klaus ended up taking Strang's spot a day after. And Strang didn't know he got dropped even after they picked up Klaus for Strang for like a good 3 or 4 days. They even played the tournament with Strang, the little Sunday tournament, whatever, the map test. Strang literally, like, didn't know he was dropped that whole time. He was playing with them on Saturday or whatever, and didn't know he was dropped.
Jeez, that's so messed up. You guys are savages. The young savages.
So all these roster changes, bro, like, I'm be honest with you, like, it's happening, but it's like, I can't even complain about the roster changes no more. Like, the season hasn't started. Season 2 hasn't started. And this is all preseason, like, off-season stuff. So, like, people getting dropped now, you shouldn't even complain about getting dropped at this point.
Yeah, it's the off season, and you know how the off season up and down, people get dropped, people get added on, and you know teams won't really form until 2 weeks, 3 weeks before the event. So you need to just get on a stable team and stop making changes, make it work. You know, schedule conflicts always happen, but you know, you got to deal with it. You guys got to break down your schedules as much as possible. You know how we were. I mean, Rob and I always have it down to a science. You know, we paid 4 or 5 days a week from this time to this time. If it didn't work out on a certain day, we changed it up and we swapped it out with another day. But that also comes with a little bit of maturity. Not saying just you in general or you in general as a whole. That's the whole community.
I've had my moments. Like, I'd be like, yo, like Ozzy, for example, like, he'll get me mad one day. Like, he wouldn't talk for a scrim, and I just get heated. I'm like, yo, let's drop this kid. Like, I'll be heated. Like, that's just my mentality. Like, I already stopped thinking like that. Like, I'm not going to keep saying, yo, let's drop this kid for no reason. Like, if a guy actually, like, doesn't want to talk or whatever, I'm going to talk to him after the match. I'm going to go, bro, like, what happened? Like, why weren't you talking? Then you need to give me the reason. Like, oh, I was pissed off because, like, I saw Flingy do a stupid play or whatever. I'm like, all right, bro, I agree. Like, all right, that's fine. Like, back then, like, when I was teaming with Clouds and them, like, I used to be like, yo, let's just drop this kid, bro. Like, I'd be like, yo, let's just drop this guy. Like, fuck Osby. Like, let's just drop him and get inside. Like, he's not talking. And, like, this whole time, it was, like, his mic issue. And I didn't know until, like, last day.
Yeah, you see, that stuff that always affects you. You as a player and you as a team. But, and hopefully you guys will settle that. And obviously, you know, going forward, hopefully Mexico is a good event for you guys, especially for you. I want to see you place pro once again, this first event going into Mexico. But
I'm literally not going to go to this event. Like, I'm making sure I place literally pro this next event. Mexico is that event where I have to place pro.
You have to. You're going to have a following there. I know a lot of people know about you out there, like you said, through the YouTube videos and through gaming. So you'll definitely have the crowd behind you. I don't doubt that. But Chris, I want to wrap it up. I want to thank you for coming on here. I know you had a lot to say about YouTube. You obviously could probably sit here and tell us everything, a little bit about something in regards to it. But I appreciate you coming on here. I will be talking to you definitely about this video once I'm done with it. But thank you for coming on. If there's anything else that you want to say, now's the time.
I don't mind helping you with the YouTube stuff. Remember to hit me up. I am going to ask you for something in the DMs about this. I want to kind of like clip this and upload it, and so you can get more views on the video, obviously. I'm going to tag your original video with the whole link after, like, a little... I'm going to use this video to upload a trailer to my channel about it, so you can get the views. All right. Mm-hmm.
That's awesome. I appreciate that. I put you in the message board as well, guys. That's his Twitter, at DomezTV. Make sure you guys follow him. Make sure you subscribe to him on YouTube as well, like you guys have heard him. And if you're just coming in now, because we've been fluctuating in numbers, this is Domes. He's a Gears of War pro player. He does a lot of content creation in regards to Gears of War, and he does have a whole bunch of ideas and plans that are working out with a bunch of other players and also content creators. So be on the lookout for that. The best way to probably get in contact with him would be at DomezTV. But Chris, thank you. Have a good night. Hey, and I'll see you in the DMs, brother. Bye. Later.
Bye-bye.
Alrighty. So that was Chris. Had a lot to say. I mean, he's a very valuable person. He knows what he's talking about in regards to Gears of War and the content creation. That is something that I think a lot more people in general and a lot more pro players need to jump on. I know myself, I am going to literally contact him after this and speak to him a little bit more about it and kind of get the YouTube expertise advice from him, just because these videos do go up on YouTube after the show. I'm going to try to switch it up a little bit and listen to him in regards to the thumbnails and so forth, because that's something that will help me grow as an individual and help the show grow. Obviously, without growth, there is no show. So I appreciate Chris coming on here and giving me plenty of advice. We're going to be moving forward. I'm going to be bringing on Strive and Rep Solid. Like I said, they are the coach and captain of Team Vanquish. They have been in Gears of War, like I said, the first season of season one. I actually played for them at Columbus, Ohio. So they are an organization that has been in the esports world, but since the first event, they actually left Gears of War and are now back. And now they have a good team. They have a good young team, Rep Solid. Like I said, the captain is going to be coming on board to the show and speaking to you guys a little bit more about that. But let me try to find them on here and we'll get it going. But like I said, these guys are from Vanquish Gaming. I'm going to have one of them call me because I don't have their username. I don't even think they added me. But that's besides the point. If you guys have any questions, like I said, put it in the chat on here. We are going to finish up tonight with Immortal Spawn. That is going to be the, I guess, the main closer of the show. So make sure you guys stay tuned for that. That should be coming up shortly. I am trying to stay on a schedule for you guys. I know I don't want to make these episodes too drawn out. That's why I always ask for the feedback. If you guys have any pros, any cons to the show, things that you think I should work on, that my guests should work on. Just a little bit of information for everybody. I am going to be getting a new overlay, like an extremely big overlay, completely brand new with different alerts, different backgrounds, a little bit more of a kind of like a sports show feel to it. So I'm extremely excited about that. I'm not going to be rushing my designer. She said she should have it in about 2 to 3 weeks, maybe even more, just because there's a little details and nicks and nacks that she works on. So that is great news, and I'm happy to say that. Once that hits, I'll be announcing that for the next episode, and so forth. So that's something for you guys to look into. But like I said, we're going to continue to have this show going. I'm trying to get in contact with Strive and Rep Solid. Once they get in on here, we're going to have a little Q&A with them as well. I'll ask them a little bit about their background, a little bit about everything else. But I am getting the call now from Josh, so stay tuned. Hello.
Hello.
What's up, buddy?
Yo, what's good?
What's happening?
Nothing. How are you?
I'm doing good.
Yeah, like Rep's here.
Can is there any way you could add him to the call?
Yeah. Let me see. See what I can do. Add him right now.
Cool. Yeah, I like it.
My headset.
Man. Yo.
What's happening?
What's good, man?
Good?
How you doing?
How's it going?
It's great, man. Chilling. So we are watching Domes. Had a whole biography on YouTube. Nice. Hey, yo, salute to that, bro.
Yeah. He really does have a lot going on with Gears of War.
The Bible, YouTube Bible. Bro. Actually, what's good though, man?
How's it going? I'm glad to have you guys on here. I like the energy already that I'm getting. You guys just got on here, and I'm really feeling it.
Super excited to be here.
Definitely, I'm happy to have you guys on here. So, for everybody in the stream, Strive is the beautiful gentleman on screen with the headset. Just so you guys know, that is Strive. He is the coach of Vanquish Gaming, and Rep Solid with the logo there, since he doesn't want to show himself, is the captain.
Nah, I gotta get my Wi-Fi on, bro. My bad.
No, you're fine.
I'm not trying to do that right now. I gotta go downstairs. Not trying to do all that.
No, you're fine. So, just to let everybody know, that is Rep, and then we have Strive as well. So, gentlemen, how's everything going? How's your guys' relationship with Vanquish Gaming? How have they been treating you?
Well, from a player standpoint, it's been going really well. You know, off the rip, I talked to Andrew, couldn't make it, unfortunately, but he was telling me he wants to make Vanquish big and Gears and such and all of that, and he was telling me that he did have a Gears of War team season 1, and he wants it big, he wants it, you know, global, top tier in Gears. So
yeah, of course. And I know you guys have a good opportunity to do that. You guys have a good young squad. You also have Atomic, who I've played with before. You have Traumasaur, who I've played with before. And yeah, I have, you know, nothing but confidence for you guys. But going into it, I know Vanquish had sold the team. I don't know if they had told you guys that or not. But were you guys aware that they had sold the organization? I know the previous owner, Chris, he was actually the guy that I worked with at the first season, first event. I think he actually sold the team. Was that disclosed to you guys? Not that it matters. This is just a Q&A.
Oh, no, of course. You know, he was straight up, man. He was a straight up guy. He told me about all of that. He told me about how long the org's been around, its origin, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Started up in Call of Duty, all of that. He's telling me about everything. So, you know, salute to Andrew, man.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Salute to him.
It's true.
Definitely. Yeah, you always got to, you know, you always got to represent the org that's going to be helping you guys out. Now, going into season 2, how confident are you guys? What are your expectations going into Mexico?
To be honest, like, going to Mexico, like, we're really confident. We really put the time in, like, behind the scenes. Like, we stopped streaming because we just got to keep everything disclosed because people be watching us for some reason. I don't know. We don't know what it is. But every time we, like, stream, we got, like, 40 views on our videos, like, on our Twitch videos. So it's just, like, we're done streaming. But we're, honestly, like, we're really confident going into the event. We are looking at, honestly, our minimum, like, in our mind is really, like, top 8. But, like, our main goal is first place, like, nothing but first. To be honest with you.
Yeah, number one, man.
Of course, and you got to be confident. You got to have that positive attitude. I tell everybody that comes up here on the show, you know, you always got to be confident in yourself and in each other, obviously. The coach, Shrive, you've been there, done that. You know, you got to keep your boys in the game. You know, you talk them up, you talk strategy, you know, proper sleep, you know, proper eating, you know what I mean? You don't want to eat bad stuff. You don't want to stay up late. So all that comes into play. Now, Rep, being that you are so young, how is it being the captain, but at a young age?
Well, I'm not the youngest on the team, but I'm pretty much in the middle of it. It's really good. Like, I've been playing with two of my teammates for, I don't know, man, almost a year.
We about was a year now. It's about a year now.
Yeah, we was honestly. ODY. Odyssey, and then we went and got, you know, your former teammates, Atomic and Trauma. Pedro thought that was the best move before Vegas. We had literally like 2.5 weeks of practice, maybe 3. And you know these guys got the worst connection. You know Atomic. So we had to deal with that, and we made the best of it. And we, you know, we got to, I mean, to people, it's a good place, and to us, it ain't nothing. But, you know what I mean? We got 13th, you know what I mean? We want to go higher than that. We want to just go past top 8. We want to be top tier in this game permanently, not a one-time thing, you know? So.
No, and I mean, you're on the right track. I mean, like you said, all the stuff you just said, you're on the right track. You guys still have the same roster that you guys had in Las Vegas, which I, you know, that's something I always recommend to everybody, having the same roster. You know, obviously, if somebody didn't play too bad, that's always the right move you want to have. You know what I mean? You're able to work with each other and kind of work forward. And that's something that most teams don't see. You know, I just had Domes on here. This guy told me like 10 different roster changes, literally, and I just couldn't keep up. And I'm like, I don't even know what is going on right now. I have no idea what to say or, you know, in regards to that. But you guys are doing it, you know, right. You guys are staying with the same roster, and that's something that you don't see. Going into the first event, Mexico City. Did either of you go to the first Mexico City event last season?
No. No, I did not. I was supposed to go, and then complications happened. So I will, but just to talk about Mexico, I will not be going to the first event with the team, because I have something going on.
Okay.
But so like that's just what's going on with the team for that. I guess put it out there for everyone to know. I will not be going, but I will be with them every tournament, no matter up till the event, just so I can be there for them. Because I feel like they deserve that, since I won't be able to be there.
No, completely understandable. And Rep, for you, what's your expectation, Mexico City? How's that for you?
Oh man, we went through a lot to get here, and I'm gonna tell you, ain't nobody gonna stop us. We on a high road right now, for real. We getting the right practice, you know, playing semi-pro, pro teams, all of that. We plan on implementing that to 2Ks and then ultimately land, you know, want to just be top tier. We expect, number one, everyone's mindset in this game is, yeah, I want to get top 8, you know, like, cool, bro, you know what I mean? Like, you get it, salute to you, but are you going to stay top 8, you going to stay top 5, or you just wanted to be a one-hit wonder? So we plan on getting top tier, staying there permanently. If we get 5th, all right, guys, yo, we got to do better next time. Let's get 3rd. Let's get 2nd. Let's get 1st. You know what I mean? Want to do that. You don't want to stay at the same spot.
Yeah, no, I like it. I mean, you obviously have the right attitude. This is crazy. I'm mad that I didn't meet you before. This is the first time I'm really talking to you officially, but I like it. It's good.
It's crazy because I know your teammates. I know Twista. I know Sam. I was talking to him at the event. All of that. You know, I actually team with Twista. And me and Trauma, it's funny because me and Trauma taught him the game. He was a mute, a savage, but just a mute, you know. And we molded him. you know.
Yeah, Mikey's a great player. Mikey's savage, Twista is he's a very talented player, very good player.
Very good.
But yeah, I would say if anything that holds him back is his communication. He is on and off with it. You know, obviously everybody has their pros and cons. It's never to put a player down. But he did. I'm sure he was very quiet when you guys played with him. But like you said, Twist has always been a very talented player. I hope to see him there, actually. I hope he goes to Mexico City. I'm not too sure his plans right now in regards to who he's going to be playing with if he decides to go to the event. Now, after Mexico City, after you guys place first, what's the plan after that? What are you guys going to work on to better improve yourselves or better improve as a team and as a whole?
Well, obviously, repeat, you know, whatever we did to get whatever placing we're going to get, like fifth, fourth, first, second, eighth, whatever, like, we want to repeat that and do more, do extra, because, like, another thing, too, is, like, don't get too full of yourself. Like, I'm pretty sure everyone knows, like, Optic was too full of themselves and fell off Mexico. They got destroyed, bro. Like, Ribs is out here dropping three pieces. You got everybody doing impossible stuff, like, and they lost. So they learned their lesson. You know what I'm saying? That's a perfect example. I can use that event. And making changes, but you got to make the right change. Like, you know what I mean? They made a roster change after that, and they're happy with it, of course. You know
Absolutely.
What I mean? But just like Domes is saying, it's way too much of it. Like, people's getting the wrong idea on it. Like, we haven't made a roster. I don't remember the last time I made a roster change, yo. Honestly, like, what? Rub Pager, right before.
It's gotta be right like June. Vegas. It's gotta be June. In June. Last time we ever made any changes to the roster where I felt like it was what we needed to move forward. So.
Yeah, man. Salute to Atomic and Trauma. You know, filling in those spots.
Facts.
Definitely
my
paid off.
To the end.
Yeah, definitely.
Really,
paid off, so.
They really came in here and did what they had to do.
Yeah, we just gonna keep this mindset. Just keep thriving. Keep going forward.
Like, I guess to answer your question and what you asked, like, if like we go to this event, I'm not gonna be there. But let's say they go there and let's just say they win. Let's just say because you said that, like. My mindset is going to be the same as it always is. Well, it's back to work, boys. We got work to do. We figure out what we did wrong, the rounds we lost. It don't matter. It don't matter what we did, how good we did, whatever. Like, we got to keep progressing, keep fixing with the mistakes. I tell them all the time, like we can't keep on, like, having the little mistakes that keep happening. Like, we got to fix them and move forward. Like the more we just keep on, like, letting the same mistakes happen, the more we're just going to keep pushing ourselves backwards, like. And I keep telling them about, like, we got to move forwards as a team. Like, that's what we got to do. So.
No, absolutely. You want to come back. You want to regroup. Like you just said, you guys talk about the good, the positives that came out of the event. Obviously, you always want to forget about the negatives. You guys got to squash all that when you get back. But obviously, that's something that, you know, you guys got to look forward to. Right now, we haven't even hit the event. But of course, once you guys hit the event, you guys are going to hit the ground running. You know, you guys are going to make that first day run, that Friday run, and then you're going to hit that Saturday. And then, of course, you always are going to end up in championship Sunday. Now,
you got to make Sunday. Yeah, done gotta that with make Friday Sunday. And Saturday. Got to make Sunday.
Yeah, got to make Sunday.
You know what I'm saying?
Of course.
Sorry to cut you off.
No, you're good.
This team right here, our biggest attribute in my mind is loyalty, because a lot of teams, like, you know, they just break up over nothing. And, like, you know, I've been teaming with the other two teammates I didn't mention, Blast and Flash. Those guys are great. They're goons. They're the youngest on the team. And that's the thing also. Like, I feel like if you're picking up a young player, like, they're just more hungry than an experienced player. And, you know, when you're younger, you have so much more to learn, and you can just soak all the information up and obviously be better than anyone that's more experienced than you. So salute to those guys. And then, again, you need experienced players as well just to balance that out. So.
No, true. I agree with that. Yeah. So that's pretty much what I have for you guys tonight. Again, I appreciate you guys for coming on. Strive, Rep. Make sure you guys follow them on Twitter. It is all over my Twitter page, the Gears of War roster. Gears of War Roster Mania Twitter page. I have their information up on there for you guys to follow them. Again, thank you two guys for coming out. Is there any last words that you have for the stream or for anybody watching?
You go, Pedro. I'll go after you.
Honestly, I just got a shout out to Vanquish. Appreciate for all they've done for us. Honestly, they've been doing a lot, like behind the scenes for us, and like shout out to the team, Trauma, Atomic, Flash, Blast. Those are my brothers to the end. Ride or die. That's all we are.
100%, yo. Shout out to the org, of course. If you want their at, is VQ Gaming HQ. My teammates, Blast, Flash, the Goonies, Trauma, best anchor in the game, and you got Atomic with the worst connection, but he's an X Factor. He's a Joker card. You don't know what he's gonna pull out. You know that, Cubano. You team with him. You know what he can do. So
I know what he can do. I agree with that. I know exactly what he can do.
You know what he can do. So
he pulls out some of the weirdest things. But yeah, I agree with that.
God, I've never heard someone talk about connection so much in that guy, yo. Crazy. But yeah, salute to him. Salute to the team. And I appreciate you tuning in. You know, watching the scrim. I seen you, man. For sure. I appreciate that.
Of course. I'm always there. I
appreciate you getting this on the show and everything.
No, not a problem.
Yeah, definitely. Very grateful.
I thank you guys for that, and you guys were a live crew, which it was great. I like that. I like to be surprised on the show. But yeah, thank you guys, and I wish you the best of luck. I'll probably be seeing you in stream or you know whatever it is. I'll make sure to stop by, talk to you guys. But again, thank you guys. Yeah. Have a good night.
One more thing. One more thing. If you want to watch a scrim, we're gonna be streaming tonight. My Twitch is Twitch. .tv/RepSolid if you want to watch Traumasaurus.
Is that regular spelled?
Yeah,
R-E-P-S?
Yeah, it is regular, yep.
All right, I'll put it on the stream for you.
100%. Appreciate that. And if you want to watch my teammate, want to get two POVs, twitch.tv/Traumasaurus. So, you know, we double stream. If you want to watch us tonight, you can. And, yeah, man. If you haven't, follow Cubano stream. If you're here, you might as well follow his stream, of course.
I appreciate that.
Media himself, so I appreciate y'all watching and taking the time out to listen in, y'all.
Thank you, my friend.
Yeah, Cubano, you have a good night, man.
You too, guys. Yeah, take care, gentlemen.
Thank you.
All right.
Later. All right, well, that was a live crew. You know, they had a lot to say, which is always good. I like the confidence, the knowledge, and the experience that they brought to the chat, and you know how they're feeling going into this event. Thank those two guys for coming out, Vanquish Gaming as well, the organization that is backing them. But now we move on to the main event tonight. So again, for anybody that's just tuning in that hasn't been here, or if you've been in here and you're ready for it, we're going to be bringing in Immortal Spawn. Now, Immortal Spawn has been a friend of mine for 10 plus years now, okay? That's 10 plus years, 1-0. Teammate of mine to this day, business partner to this day with Raw Talent in the background. We co-own our own gaming team. He now owns Trickstrat, which is what we're going to be talking about tonight. He is going to be speaking about it. He does have an app that's already out for iOS and as well as Android. It's very cool. If you guys haven't yet, make sure you go to their Twitter page. It's right on the screen for you guys, at Trickstrat. You could go there, and there's also the link to download it for your computer. And it's pretty neat. I think you guys are going to enjoy it. He has a lot to say. I have a couple of good questions for him in regards to his app. We're also going to catch up a little bit together on the show live with you guys. So let me get the Immortal Spawn on. But wait, do you guys hear that? Are you guys hearing that? Nah, something must be messed up.
Nah, that can't be coming through. This doesn't sound right. There's no way. I must have... Okay. Okay. It just takes over. I don't understand what's going on right now. This is amazing. The music, it just takes over. I don't get it. That just got weird. I don't know. I'm sorry about that, guys. I apologize. That was a little bit of an audio difficulty that just happened. But yeah, I don't know what that was about. But let me try to get a mortal spawn in on here. And now I feel awkward. But yeah, let's see if I can grab him. There's Rob. Hello, Rob. Hey, buddy.
There we go. Yeah, I'm dancing in my seat over here, man. That was
you heard
the
it?
The perfect intro. Yeah, I heard it. Loved it.
There it is. I was
don't
like,
hear the music anymore though. I don't
oh,
hear
it,
anymore,
probably, it probably cut it off. Oh man.
It might still be on. I just had to mute the stream.
No, but, it's okay.
That was, you know, I wouldn't want it any other way. I love it. Thank you.
I figured you'd love that. So, Rob, I'm excited to have you on here. Everybody, this is Immortal Spawn, at Immortal Spawn, my teammate, friend, business partner, lover at one time, but now he's engaged to Nicole, his fiance. Congratulations to them for everyone that hasn't seen it yet on Twitter. I'm happy for the two of them, both good friends of mine. He is also the creator of Trickstrat. We are going to be talking about that tonight. Rob, I know you're excited about it. I was excited for you. I had no idea when you were dropping this. I know you hinted at it, which was awesome. But I'm glad you did it the way you did it. And going into it tonight, I want you to introduce yourself. I know most people in here already know you, but for the video later on down the road and for some family and friends of mine that are watching the show, introduce yourself a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. So my name's Rob Immortal Spawn. I've been competing in Gears since the very beginning on the Game Battles ladders when it first started and started with MLG. And Gabe and I started teaming together, as he mentioned, at the start. Actually, we played together at the end of Gears 1 and played together as raw talent at the start of Gears 2. And, you know, it's been great. It's actually my first time on the show, so I'm really excited to be here. It's been a long time that I've been wanting to get on, and this was a perfect opportunity to finally join you. So hopefully, you know, definitely won't be the last. I'm real excited about that. So, but yeah, we competed together, Gabe and I, in the last season of Gears, and we're excited about where Gears is going and the future of it. And yeah, it's all good there. So.
Of course. Awesome. A little intro of Rob. Rob and I could talk for days with you guys about our relationship and about gaming careers and so forth. But Rob, we're going to jump into the meat and potatoes of the show tonight. I know you just recently announced Trickstrat, which I've been pushing since the beginning of this episode. An app that Rob just dropped in designing and so forth. It is on iOS as well as Android. He's going to be talking about this tonight. If you guys have any questions in the stream, make sure you put it in the chat. I'll try to get out as much as possible to Rob. But Rob, how did the launch go? How was it up to your expectation? Give me a little bit about that.
Sure. The launch has been incredible. So the app went live yesterday morning. The response has been fantastic. It really proved to me that there's a desire for a tool like this. And, you know, Trickstrat has been my baby for a long time. For those, as Gabe, you mentioned, you didn't even know about it. My teammates knew I was working on something in esports, but that was the extent of it. So since the launch, the feedback and the suggestions, all positive. But overall, like I'm very happy to have crossed that mark where I can focus on what's next for the app.
Yeah, absolutely. And yeah, it came to a complete surprise to myself. And, you know, we obviously have always talked to each other about most things, but you always have a way of doing the things the right way. And like I said, I'm happy that you kept it that way just because, you know, it's a little bit more special to you and more special to somebody like me who's like, wow, this guy was not working on something simple. You were working on something that was huge, you know, something with extreme potential to it, which is pretty sweet.
I really wanted that. Like, I really wanted you to be surprised. I wanted everybody to sort of have that, that exposure to it when it went live for the first time. And I didn't mention at the beginning, I'll just clarify, Trickstrat is it's an esports drawing app, and it's a tool used for competitive gamers to draw strategies on the fly, pull up an overhead view of a map, visualize their positioning on the battlefield, and build teamwork and improve your game. So that's the app. That's the goal overall, is to make people better.
Awesome. Yeah, that's something that I know you've been doing for so many years. I mean, you are literally the originator to that. I don't care what anybody says. You've been doing this since 2008, and that's only when I met you. You've been playing since God knows how long. And you're a young guy too, which is even crazier to think about that, that you've been doing it for so long at such a young age. And now you've been able to bring it to the tech world, which is, awesome. You went from paper like you used to do. Hey, Gabe, you're going to go here on this piece of paper. This is you, a dot. And you drew me this way. And I'm like, got it, Dad. We got it. We're going to do this.
Right.
And now you got it on an app, which I think is awesome. The fact that you're able to put it on an iPad, I think, is sweet. So one thing I wanted to ask you, because obviously I'm sure that's a question that a lot of people are going to ask, the million-dollar question. How did you settle on the name Trickstrat?
That's a great question. It really was like a shower thought. It was one of those aha moments that you have. Prior to settling on that name, I think I was referring to it as like strat board or something general like that. And, I really started thinking about, what is this I'm building? Like, how do I encompass the tool, into a single name? And, my teammates and I have been using Trickstrat for several years now. And what is it that we were doing? And at some point it just clicked to me, you have your base strats, and but it's really important to, it's really important when you run the Trickstrat, that it's designed and it's executed correctly. And that was my aha moment. It was, I think I ran to my fiance at the time, and I remember just going up to her and being like, babe, Trickstrat. That's it. That's the name of the app. It's going to be Trickstrat. Like it was just that, it just felt right at the time. And she's been incredibly supportive of me throughout all of the development. Nicole's often, studying away at her med school rotations, and Trickstrat's really been the game that I've been grinding on. It's been this project that, I've just been working hard on, and there's definitely been some moments where I'm banging my head against the wall, as any of you developers know. But she's kept me focused and really believed in the idea. So the term Trickstrat, really stems from my Gears experience, ultimately. And I'm not even positive if the term is, has the same meaning in other esports, but it definitely has a lot of meaning to us. So.
No, of course. Trickstrat is, like you said, it's not something you probably hear about in, other esports games, but you never know. Obviously we haven't played that much. I know we do a fair share of gaming on Call of Duty, Halo, PC games, right? Pretty much every PC game you've played, I've ended up playing, because I'm like, if you have it, I gotta have it. But you know what? It's a name. It's catchy. So the minute you start throwing maps in there and different game types, and we do have a question for you, Rob. I'm going to put that later, but we have a couple of questions in the chat already, which is awesome. But that is kind of along the lines of one of the questions that we have for you. But
sure.
Now that Trickstrat has been launched, I know, I'm sure you was waiting. You've been putting a lot of time, a lot of sweat, a lot of effort into it. How are you feeling now that it's live?
Okay. I'm just really like incredibly relved that it's out there now. That has to be the main thing. It was probably like one of the most nerve-wracking things. I recall like just driving on the highway like over the last couple months, and God forbid something was going to happen to me, and I'm just thinking like, no one is going to know what I built. Like, I've worked so hard on this thing and no one will ever know about it. Now that feeling is gone, I feel really good and relieved, and I'm generally excited for what's next.
Yeah, I know that, like you said, that was a big relief that you had. You launched it. I know you said you didn't get many bugs, many crash. You've been doing really well with it, which is always good to hear. I know we talked about that a little bit yesterday, and that's great. You know, obviously, the fact that you were able to launch such an awesome project with so much time and effort that you put into it with zero, I guess, mistakes or any problems on the first day is, you know, unbelievable, and you don't really see it often. Anytime you see something in the tech world, and you know more than me, launches, there's always seems to be an issue or something seems to crash. But with all the amount of traffic that you've been getting and the users that have been signing on, I know the numbers that you've been telling me have been insane, which is awesome. And if you wanted to touch on that as well, anything?
Yeah, well, in terms of, like, you know, I was prepared for the worst, and, you know, the worst didn't happen yesterday. Like, what's the worst case scenario you can think of, right? You launch something and, you know, a bunch of people are like, I can't get in, or this isn't working, or that isn't working. So I was prepared for that, because you have to be. And I was ready to put out any fires. But, you know, thankfully, there wasn't anything of that magnitude. I was very relieved about that. And I'm happy that, you know, people were able to get in there and start using it. And, you know, really start flooding me with suggestions and feedback, and it's been really exciting. So, you know, I again, like, thank everybody for embracing it so much, and I really want to, you know, bring everything that everybody wants to the tool. Like, that's my goal. So,
absolutely, and I know that's a question I'll have for you in a little bit in regards to gaming and whatnot. But from TrickStrat, I know we have a lot of questions into it, but what do you hope the general community or people in general will get out of using your app called TrickStrat?
Yeah, so it really stems, like, the biggest reason why I wanted to build this tool. So, you know, the reason I wanted to build it is because we've proven that it improves teamwork. Like, we've been using it, and for a while, you know, whatever form we were using the tool, it's improved teamwork, and as a competitor, I know that. So, you know, there hasn't been an accessible way for you know, esports competitors to get in there to have access. So, you know, that was the goal. But, like, growing up for myself, I competed, you know, in soccer and basketball leagues, and those activities were all about building teamwork. You know, we had a lot of team building methods. But there was always a clipboard involved. There was always a clipboard at the beginning of the game or at halftime where my coach was showing me what to do. You know, I'm, like, you know, little 3-4 foot tall, and, you know, we're all, like, taking knees and sitting around. And we were always building that teamwork. So, reviewing plays, positions, you know. So when I entered competitive gaming, I naturally wanted that. I grew up with that experience. I wanted the huddle, right? I demanded the huddle from you guys. I wanted all the elements of that. Being on a team makes you feel good. It makes you feel, you know, like you're part of something. It brings you together. It makes you want to win together. So, you know, having a tool like this, you know, we actually used a prototype of this at Winter Brawl 9. I have a link that if we could pull up, I'll send you of us from Winter Brawl 9. It's super funny. So, but yeah, so basically, like, having a tool and being able to review plays with the team. So, you know, you can talk. It's really like another form of communication when you think about it. Mm. Yeah, we can talk on the mic about a 2v1 situation, right? Or we can talk on the mic about how I want you to flank the next guy. But when you see the image, when you visualize it, that's a different level. Like, maybe the words don't do it, but the image before the match, or the image in between the next game, that might stick. And, you know, now that in its simplest form is in your head, and you won't mess it up next time. So it's the.
I think you cut out, Rob. Are you guys able to hear Rob? Rob, I don't know if I hear you. Yeah, we couldn't hear you, Rob. Can you guys hear me on the chat? We're gonna get Rob back in here. Just let me know if you guys can hear me.
Yeah, they can hear you.
Oh, okay. All right, good.
All right. How are we now? Do you have an echo?
No. I think it's good.
Okay. I apologize.
You're good.
I charged this headset up until the show, and I love this headset, but apparently it wasn't charged enough. So my apologies. As long as there's not an echo, I won't rush and go get another headset.
No, I'm good. As long as everybody in the chat, if you guys hear an echo, let us know before we really get into it. But yeah, I think you're good right now on my end. You sound good.
So I don't know if I cut off in the middle of that.
You did a little bit. Yeah, you were out for a little bit. So if you wanted to recap, if you remember, or we could continue to move forward, whatever you think.
Yeah, in terms of basically like what do I hope people get out of using Trickstrat? I was mentioning that like it's another form of communication, really. You know, I can talk to you about a 2v1 situation, but when you see it, it sticks. It's a different form. It sticks in your head, and you know, maybe you won't mess it up next time, especially like right before a match. So, you know, the biggest thing that I want people to get out of the tool is building teamwork, bonding. Improving their game, and you know, I hope people get creative and you know, come up with some strats you know, during the day and integrate them into their scrims at night. You know, it's a tool that I've been using, and I'm happy that you know, the platform is there for others to do the same thing. So
yeah, absolutely, this is a little bit of what you've been doing for so long, and now people are going to be able to do that themselves. And like I mentioned earlier, because we had a coach on here from one of the newest teams, I think that's a coach's thing. You know, a coach should be able to download this app and do what you did. You brought that huge iPad Pro that was like this big and was like, guys, this is the map. And you put you put the weapons down, you drew them, and you put – it was like a football. It was like a what do you call that? Like you just said, a little chalkboard there. You're erasing everything and writing it there. I think it's a pretty neat idea, and if people actually see it in use at events, it's going to be even bigger. I think in Mexico it's going to be a huge hit. I mean, I'm sure they got word of it. I'm sure it eventually hit the Latin American scene sooner than later. But I think it's going to blow up. It's only going to, you know, go up from here. But in regards to it, Rob, was there anything else that you'd like to share personally with myself in the stream?
I sent you a little link we can pull up based on that Winter Brawl 9 comment that I had. So if you're able to, we can do that now. If not, I'll just get into the next thing. But can you pull something up?
Of course. Well, I'm going to try. Are you going to send it to me through email?
Oh, I sent it to you on the Skype.
Oh, on the Skype. Okay, let me see.
Yeah, wherever. Yeah, it's a YouTube link.
Actually, yeah, this could work.
Might be able to play it there. I'm not sure.
Oh, no, it took me right to... Yeah, it took me right to... let me see. I think I'll be able to add it.
See if you can play it there and full screen it. I'm not sure.
Let's see. Yeah, whenever I click it, it just takes me to Internet Explorer. Let me see if I could add. I think I could do this. We'll try to make this work. Browser source, if I'm not mistaken. All right, I think that's the link. Should be able to get this. If I get this, I'll be shocked.
It's no big deal. If you can, we can.
Hey, there it is. Where is?
Okay, yeah, I see the OBS studio link.
Do you see the video now?
No, I see. Well, I might be delayed, but I see the OBS studio on your screen. Yeah, I see the video. All right, just play it through for everybody, because we were actually like using a prototype of Trickstrat during this event, and I thought it'd be funny to just catch up on it. For, you know, a lot of people probably haven't seen this before, and they'll recognize some faces.
Boy, this is awesome. Woo! There he is. He had the poster board. Oh, there's little Ment. Raw talent, baby. Woo! I love it. I like this. Sub Zero. Chubbs. For everyone that doesn't know, this is Chubbs. PR, coach of Ghost Gaming now. It's great to see all these faces that completely either left the game, coaching, on a pro team. Oh, I don't think I remember these guys.
He shot Taibu. Oh no. Noxious. Strang. Yogurt, obviously. Jake, nasty. They need to bring these back.
I know, aren't they great?
These are great.
They had the hero shots that we did, yeah. These were just like quick snippets, though.
Brian's great. Fran with the dancing, I love it. For everybody in here watching, this is a video, or you could say the prototype for Immortal Spawn and Trick Strat. If you guys didn't see it, he was writing on his board. He actually drew out Checkout, one of the maps in the game. Put his lines, put his X's for maps and locations.
We used the iPad that whole event.
Absolutely, which that's something that so you understand this is something that's been in the making for a long time now. Yeah. But now it's actually surfaced, obviously. So we're going to finish out this video. This is something like a hero shot, like Immortal said, that they do now. Season 1, they did this. Season 2, obviously, they're going to continue. But this was a pretty cool video in regards to that. Funny. But yeah, no, that's... I appreciate that video. We're going to cut that off so we can see. All right. Now we're back. But yeah, if you guys saw it, like I said, Immortal was on there drawing on his huge board. He did actually draw that out right then and there in person.
That's right.
Which I thought was pretty cool. We actually had to wait for you to get done, which was hilarious. But yeah, pretty neat idea. And like I said, you've been working on this for a while now. I mean, just look at that. But yeah, now I know we had a couple of questions in the stream. Let me go back up and ask them.
And if we do have time, I do have a quick lesson prepared.
Yes.
Time.
We have questions. I mean, we have time for that. I make time for that. You know this. But the first question, Rob, was a little earlier. Green Eggs and Sam, the app is such a great idea. Question, when can we expect maps from other games?
Yeah. Well, of course, that was, a big thing to integrate, as many games as possible. So I'm working as hard as I can to get more titles in there soon. I have my idea of the next games I want to bring in. So, I can, of course, guarantee that maps, other games are coming. I don't have any set dates to give you right now. But and that's been one of the... greatest things, I think, from launching this is, I knew it would hit the Gears network, and I knew that people know me and what I'm about, and kind of understood this. But it's been awesome seeing the passion from other esports titles, and of course, I know how passionate one can be about their game. And of course, launching with Gears was important for me for a lot of reasons and something I wanted to do for everybody. I know how important it is to and want a tool for other games. So I'm working as hard as I can to make that happen. So I guarantee they're coming. I don't have any dates for you today, though.
Yeah, just to back up Rob on that, Rob does have a huge plan to bring out, new games, hopefully new maps in general for Gears of War, Call of Duty, all the big titles, you guys name it, he's going to do it. It just does take a lot of time, does take a lot of effort. Rob is a very busy man. He has his full-time job that he's very successful at. He does a lot of computer work, a lot of side jobs that he's doing. I mean, this guy's been working like an animal since we've been gaming together, competing at a full-time level, working at a full-time level, full-time job with Nicole. She could be a pain all the time. So she's a job on its own. So it does take a little bit of time, but I promise you, I'll be on Rob. I push him as much as possible. Yeah. He pushes me as much as possible to be successful, but there will be more games coming soon enough. Leap, and if I'm not mistaken, Austin, if that is you, let me know in the chat. But Leap said, question, sooner or later, can we build map callouts with lines and save them to share to the team?
So can we build map callouts with lines? So to answer the question about saving, that is a big deal and a big feature that I absolutely want to bring in the Trick Strat. there's a lot of features that I want to bring in, and you know, launching with the features that were there and ready to go was important to me. But I'm hearing the things, and I have my backlog of awesome things that I know as a competitor would want to have, and saving is definitely one of those things. So yeah, that's definitely on the list for sure.
Awesome. Now, another question from Leap. I mean, this guy is on it today, and I like the question. He said, can we at some point, as an online group, so that each person on a team sitting at home can open up the app and talk about mistakes, etc. Quick start online view. I guess that's the name of the title. He would call it.
Quick start online view. Can I do that? yeah. Once again, amazing feature that we can, you know, as a competitor can already think about and be like, hey, how can I use this tool? I want to be able to draw, and I want my teammate to see it. So of course I'm hearing that, and as a competitor, that makes complete sense. So yep, I understand the need, the want, the desire for that. I think it's awesome, and yeah, stay tuned for any additional awesome features. But please keep asking questions and sending me, you know, any sort of ideas that you have for sure.
Yeah, that's I mean, that's a good idea in regards to being able to open up the app and talk to each other. I think that goes a little bit deeper into it in a good way, being that may be something that I guess a bigger company comes in and offers support with that. Maybe like a Skype thing, you know what I mean? You could open up Skype while you're inside the app and talk to each other through that, or, you know, do it all on your own. I don't know. You are a man of a lot of talent, so I don't know what you can or can't do.
I'll just mention on that anything is possible. We can assume that anything's possible. No, you know, that's always good. But I mean, think about the situation. If you're at your computer chair, you're at your gaming station, you're already talking to your team. You know, the main thing is to be able to see the map together. And that makes sense. I follow that point. Mm-hmm. But you know, you, like I said, you're already there. You're already talking on Xbox or talking on, you know, whatever you're doing. So, but you know, being able to share that that experience together, that strategy together, is definitely understood and taken.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds cool. I'm sure it's a lot of work behind it, so we will see it hopefully eventually. But we'll go on to the next question. We have official endorse, if I'm not mistaken. What is your opinion on, actually, no, we'll go ahead and skip that question. I can't really understand it. Let me see. Will we be able to upload? Yes, from Boomer Live TV. You've played against him, Rob, at the local Microsoft event.
Yeah, Boomer.
Boomer, his question, will we be able to upload our own maps to draw on?
So you're interested in uploading maps of just whatever maps to the platform? I've heard that one a couple times. So, yeah, it's possible. I'll consider it, as a feature. To me, I want to provide the game and all of the competitive maps that make sense, from that level. I've heard that comment a couple times. So, yeah, once again, like another feature idea that is just amazing feedback, and it's awesome to hear people think about things that I may not have thought about. So, I'm hearing everybody's opinion on it, so I appreciate it. So I'll keep that one in mind too.
Absolutely. So we have another question. Q for Rob. Is there a time frame you can give us for the release of the rest of the esports maps for Gears?
So, you know, I know that a lot of maps are being tested right now. So I could say that I want to be sure that, you know, the maps that are going to be competed on make it to the game. So as soon as that list gets finalized, I'll get working and update the Gears maps.
Yeah, I mean, that's something I'm sure you're going to be getting a lot of questions on in regards to that. Joe Ball says, question, will you tell my best friend I said hi?
Hey Joe, thanks for tuning in, bro. Joe has been very helpful as well. I want to thank him for me pestering him with questions through the day, and checking in on my on the status. You know, he's been my heartbeat through this as well. So I appreciate him beyond words. So thank you, Joe.
No, I know Joe's always been there. Joe's been there for you for years. Joe's been there for us at events. Guys, if you don't know Joe yet, Joe is pretty much our coach, manager, friend. I mean, he owns many different titles in regards to his relationship with Rob, especially, and with me. Joe is part of the family at this point with me and with Raw Talent. I went ahead and put Joe Ball's Twitch link on the stream. Make sure you guys follow Joe. He does stream a lot of games, a lot of PC games. He hasn't invited me to a game in a while, even though I've been asking him to. But that's fine. We'll not talk about that. And yes, what Gabby said, Joe's like the team mom. I think that's probably the best way to put it. Joe's definitely the team mom for Raw Talent. So we thank him for that.
Yeah, he made sure we were fed and had water at our last tournament, so that's where that analogy comes from.
Exactly. So Boomer, I know you said other game. All right, so Boomer had another question, but I think you could pretty much answer it. He just had said, is there going to be any other games, or is it just Gears? And I know you pretty much answered that already, unless you wanted to talk about it again.
Absolutely, the other games. That was key here. You know, Gears was the inspiration from my history and everything, and it's, you know, it's what I've built is just everything that I've been about. So, but the, you know, it's set up and able to support all the esports games. So there will be more titles coming.
Absolutely. And like we said, it will take time, but you guys can be sure to see more games coming out. There was something that I wanted to see here. John New Jersey. I'm wondering if I know him. John New Jersey, if I know you, make sure you put it in the chat so I kind of could identify you. But he says, is what you are doing legal? And before Rob answers that, Rob is always takes things very serious. I take things very serious. Rob has done every single thing possible to make this company as legal as possible. He's talked to an attorney that he has that he works personally with on this project. So you see Trickstrat as it is in full form, as legal as possible. And I'm sure Rob can talk about this a little bit more.
Yeah, I'll just mention that I want this tool to facilitate and help you know, gamers, companies, to bring exposure. You know, you might be in one esports title, you get exposed to another through the platform. So I think it's a great way to sort of take a game and bring it further. It's like a companion in a way. You know, it goes along with it in a lot of ways, and maybe one exposes you to other titles, or just enhances your experience. So that's, you know, that's been the goal all along.
Definitely. And Monster in the chat said, what's this about? Monster, we are talking about Trickstrat. If you see it on the screen, it's at Trickstrat. We're doing a Q&A on a gaming app that was just released. The gentleman next to me, Immortal Spawn, is the actual creator of it. You could follow Trickstrat on Twitter, and you can follow him as well for more information on the app. Make sure you do download it, especially if you're a big gamer, especially if you're on a team or an organization. I think it was a tool that you would like. Not too sure if you play games, if you're just in here kind of chatting around, asking about it, but that's just a little bit of a quick breakdown for you. Now, Rob, I know you said you had something for us, or had something that you wanted to talk about or bring up.
I just thought you know, it'd be a good opportunity to do a little lesson. It's been a long time since I was able to do a video like that. So if you guys are ready, we can segue into a little bit of a Professor Immortal time.
Yeah, I like it. Let me give you the floor. We'll blow up Rob here. Rob is going to be doing a lesson for you guys. I'm going to give Rob most of the screen, guys. I'm going to tweet this out. Make sure you guys please retweet it. We are going to get a live lesson
from the Professor Immortal Spawn on his application at Trickstrat. Make sure you follow them and you follow him on Twitter at Immortal Spawn. Guys, I'm going to be sitting here. I'm going to mute my mic. I'm going to be tweeting all this out. But Immortal Spawn, take it away.
All right, Gabe. Thank you. So, yeah, this isn't going to be one of the long videos I've done in the past. But if you've seen some of my content before, I've done a lot of whiteboard breakdowns. And this time, I thought it'd be cool to sort of pick one topic that we can talk about a little bit. And that topic today, as I adjust the camera just perfect so you guys can see the screen and myself, that looks pretty good to me. So we're actually going to hop into DAM, and the topic that I want to talk about is sort of just the metagame itself, like at a tournament. And the reason I want to do that is because that was one of the big benefits of having Trickstrat at a LAN where you're in a huddle and you're able to talk. Gabe can talk about this as well, and he can echo that we've done a lot of thinking ahead when we plan our strategies and we plan a tournament. When we're going into our next game, we're not just thinking about the next round. We're thinking several rounds ahead. And that's what I hope some people can take away from this lesson today is you need to think rounds ahead. And a lot of teams sleep on that. A lot of teams don't practice this enough. I know that just competing against different teams. What you want to do is you actually want to teach your opponent. You want to repeat things and make your opponent expect you to do something, but actually do something else. Thinking rounds ahead allows you to throw in a trick strat or throw in something unconventional and take advantage of what you already taught your opponent to do. So, an example of that would be like in chess, you always think moves ahead in chess because you have to in order to succeed at that. Or in football, you run on first down, but you take a shot on second down, or you milk the clock. These are all strategic elements because you're planning out your next move. So in Gears, it's the same thing. You would start the game and you sort of want your opponent to get used to something. So one example I have is Dam. So on the map Dam, most of the attention is going to be up at the top where you want to get map control, and most players are going to head up there. They want to go and they want to, bang out at B. But there's also this fight that occurs at the platform. And the platform is this often 1v1 type fight. You have one player that usually goes to the platform. I know there might be a little bit of a glare on this setup today, but there's Cosmo just running by my lesson, if you noticed him. So there's this 1v1 fight that happens at platform. So that's what we're going to focus on. At the start of the game, you talk to your team and you say, round one, we're going to do this. We're going to do this base strat. We're going to send most of our players to B, but we're going to have this 1v1 over at the platform, right? Round two, we're going to do the same exact thing. We're going to send most of our players over to B. We're going to focus on that fight. But it's round three that you can think ahead and already plan for before you start the game. And round three is where you actually have a player sneak all the way around, super secret, dark secret, all the way around, where that player going to plat is not expecting this at all. Yeah, he might be looking for it, but you already taught him that this is a 1v1 fight. And you get your teammate to hug the wall all the way to the edge. And he's able to hug this wall all the way to the edge and come around the opposition, the guy right here. Because you don't want to engage on him right away. If you engage on him right away, you may have missed the opportunity to get that kill. The whole purpose of doing something like this, teaching your opponent this normal strat that you're doing and then throw them off with something like this, is to guarantee that kill. Guaranteeing that kill can open up the whole round. It can guarantee you the win of that round. So you wait until this player gets behind him, where this player is waiting, not engaging in a 1v1, sitting there, able to contain him. And as soon as you have him in that 2v1 situation, you're able to pinch and secure the kill. So the whole purpose of this, again, is to think rounds ahead. And we can talk about it a little bit more, but I know for the last tournament, you know, I remember us playing on Forge, and we would, you know, round one, we're doing this, round two, we're doing this, round three, we're doing this. And if you do that before the game, and everybody knows what's going on and where they're supposed to be, and when you mix up the strats, base strat, trick strat, you know, the other base, whatever it may be, it allows you to focus on the little things in between those rounds that you need to clean up, and you don't have to waste that airtime in between the rounds where you may have to, you know, talk about what are we doing, what's the next strat, what are we going to do for the next strat. So, you know, the takeaway again is plan out your strats ahead of time if you can. You know, escalation is an interesting game where it's like you got to do like maybe three or four. Maybe you can plan out the first three or four strats. But being able to do that will allow your whole team to be ready, and it'll allow you to execute something like this where you've done this base and everybody's sort of gotten used to it, and then you're able to throw in something completely different where they, you catch that player off guard because he was used to something already. So, think about gears and when you're competing in these longer round-based matches, and think ahead and plan out your strategy a little bit. So that definitely goes a long way. Thank you guys. Coming back to my couch.
Very cool.
Cool.
Yeah. Again, not something I expected for you to do. It is an immortal spawn thing of you to do. That's just what you do. I mean, you like to teach. You're probably going to be a teacher eventually. I could see that in the near future. But yeah, no, that was awesome. That was a live demonstration, guys, from Rob, pretty much showing you guys the ins and outs of Trick Strat. Pretty neat, not gonna lie. I did not know this ahead of time. This was a last minute thing he just did right now and brought it up. But that was pretty cool. I mean, the fact that you broke it down a little bit and you had a live demonstration, that is pretty neat. And I'm sure people enjoyed it. But yeah, I know Green Eggs and Sam was happy. He said, Coach Rob, love it. So yeah, maybe we could see that in the near future, Rob. Did you ever think you would coach, or you're taking the back seat for a while?
Yeah, there's a lot of ways I would love to be involved. I've never ruled out coaching. If the right opportunity came along, I would entertain it. So that's sort of my answer on the whole coaching topic.
Absolutely, yeah. And of course, you'd be prepared because, I mean, you already have your own app. So you'd be like, yeah, guys, I could coach. Hold on, let me pull up my own app. Boom. Right there, ready to go. We have the guns. We have the strategies, guys. Don't worry, we got this, baby. But yeah, no, I think that would be pretty neat. In regards to anything else, Rob, was there anything else you wanted to talk about in general? Any ideas, any topics, questions, concerns? Now is the time for that.
Oh, it's been a pleasure. Coming on to the show. For those who haven't checked out Trick Strat yet, you can visit the web app, trickstrat.com. It's in Android and iOS marketplaces. Please send me your feedback. Send me any suggestions, any issues, whatever. I'm open ears and just, you know, my goal through all of this is to, bring a tool that didn't exist for everybody. There have been tools along the way. There have been a lot of ideas around this along the way. Kickstarter projects here or there, whatever it may be. But at the end of the day, you know, what I want is I just want competitors to, you know, have a platform to get better. And however that happens, you know, I'm excited for the future. I hope more people get involved in this. I hope there's more options, and I hope game devs see that this is very useful. It'd be awesome to see them integrate something like this. I've been waiting forever for something like when you're starting up your gears match and on screen I can show you with my controller where everybody's going, you know. So, you know, there's a lot of cool things. There's a lot of benefit to tools like this, and I hope more tools pop up. I hope more companies get involved and see the benefit of the helping the esports community out. So we've already seen a big shift in game development companies with esports in general. So, you know, maybe this is another spoil to that in the future. So, yeah, I'm excited overall. And your show has been great. I've been love watching your show. And I'm happy to be here, and I hope you bring me back.
Of course. Yeah, no, I loved having you on the show. I know you had a lot to explain to everybody in the stream. Like you said, this is a tool that I could definitely see in esports. After the show, obviously, I always upload it. I am going to talk to Chris, though, in regards to YouTube and, you know, like the backdoor things right. You could do in regards to it. But, of course, the whole goal to this episode was to help you kick off your TrickStrat app and your Twitter. Again, everybody that was in the stream and people that are watching this recorded afterwards, make sure you guys follow TrickStrat, follow Mortal Spawn. He's the creator. He's the original professor of Gears of War. The guy's been doing it. I'll probably like 2002. I'm just going to – something crazy. I'll throw it out there. The guy's been doing it forever. He's been doing it on paper. He's been doing it on little post-it notes. Hey, guys, all right, I have the little map here, but we're going to make it work. So he's done it all. I appreciate him coming on the show. We are going to have him, I'm sure, once again. Rob is going to be one of our big sponsors for the show, Gears of War Roster Mania, like I said, with the new overlay. We're going to be bringing on new sponsors and new partnerships, hopefully. We did have certain people watching the episode tonight, and I appreciate them being here through the whole episode, looking through the chat the whole time. I'm glad you guys are watching. I'm glad we were able to entertain you, hopefully. And I appreciate you guys for all watching. Rob, once again, thank you. I'll have you on here, of course, you know, soon enough, once again. And if there's anything else to say, now's the time. Your proper send-off.
Ah, thank you. Thank you again. Yeah, you can follow me at Immortal Spawn and make sure to follow the show and tune in next week. I'm excited for who's going to be on. So thanks, Gabe.
Definitely. All right, Rob. Well, it was always good chatting with you. I'm sure we'll catch up soon enough. Thank you, and have a good night, brother.
Yeah, you too. See ya.
Later. All right, everybody. Well, that concludes the special guest for the night. Again, I had a good crew tonight. We were missing Panda, one of the girl gamers in this community. She did have a personal issue that came up, but I will have her on next week's episode, so we do have one special guest already set in stone for next week. A big thing about next week that I didn't want to say with all the special guests in here, I didn't want anybody to feel guilty or have to do a little extra, is that next week's episode is going to be very dear to me. Now, you may think I said that about this episode, which I didn't, or about the episodes in the past, but next week's episode is my birthday. My birthday is September 7th, and that is next Thursday. Most of you would be like, why are you even having an episode? Now, yeah, I could do that. Yeah, I could take the day off. But you know what? The grind never stops, even for my birthday. It's just every other day. It's just the day that I was brought into this world. And I feel the need to run my show. And I'm obviously going to try to continue to do better every week. And, you know, obviously, I appreciate all the follows I had tonight. I think I probably had over 50 new followers alone tonight and within the first hour or so. So the continuous support from you guys and the follows on Twitter and, you know, obviously, eventually on YouTube as well. If you guys could subscribe to that, I'll have the video probably uploaded sometime tomorrow. But all that support is appreciated. The people that were here watching live, the people that are going to be watching this, watching the recording on YouTube, you know, this show wouldn't be anything without you guys. Like I said, I appreciate all the support. That new overlay that's going to be coming out, it's going to be a Sports Center like overlay. We're going to have a little bit more action on the actual screen. We're going to have a lot of sponsorship slots, and I am currently talking to multiple orgs and different companies in regards to filling those sponsorship slots. I am going to be working with Hype Gaming. I am going to be working with TrickStrat and Mortal Spawn. We are going to be working as a partnership between the two of us. And I expect all that to drop, I would say, at least next month, maybe middle of September, late September. But once I do get all that information and all my sponsors sign on the board, we're going to have another big show. Maybe I'll make that show a show with all the, you know, representatives of the companies that I'll be working with. So you could assure that Immortal Spawn will be there on that, you know, anniversary episode. But again, I appreciate you guys for coming out. And wait, is that me? That can't be me. There's no way. Oh, sorry. I didn't know you guys were still there. I thought this was over. I thought I pressed stop streaming. What's going on? There's no way. I'm actually still live. Well, that's embarrassing. Well, again, thank you guys for coming out. Gears of War Roster Mania. We're only going to get better each and every week, each and every month. Make sure you guys follow the stream. Follow me on Twitter at NJCUBANO. I hope you love the show. All the feedback is appreciated. Make sure you DM me directly. Any questions, concerns, or feedback, I appreciate. Again, love you guys. Have a good night. And see you next Thursday, September 7th, my birthday, 9 p.m. Be there or be square. Later.